All right, and I believe that we are live and direct. The April return of the one and only twitch.tv/GuzmanGaming1. Welcome to PC Tag and Chill number 29, 1 year anniversary edition. We are here and ready to go. Yesterday we had BB Tag and Chill tonight. Today, it might be tonight in a couple of hours for you East Coast folk out there. But either way, we got some great PC tag action, a nice bracket, and some moolah on the line. What's up with Coach Kraken? My name is Kraken Atkins. Joining me today, we do have the one and only Lana Lily on the mics. How are you doing, Lon?
Yo, I am doing good, Atkins. I am very, very excited to be celebrating the 1 year anniversary of BB Tag and Chill. It's been such a fun adventure watching all these players and even myself participate in these tournaments for a year now, which seems really crazy. But today, yes, as I can say, we will be on my home turf, the PC Tags. We have a lot of wonderful, great players here today to show off what they got.
Absolutely. I'm ready to get on with it. You know, the last month was pretty soggy. You know, no Guzman Gaming tournaments. I think a lot of people were just lost in the world on what to do with their weekends as BB Tag players, including myself. You know, nothing to talk about on weekends. Found a couple of things to, you know, other assets of the community as far as like some nice BB Tag tournaments. But very happy to have Guzman back in a big way with this $100 pop bonus for BB Tag and Chill yesterday and PC Tag and Chill today. So yeah, in case you guys want to check out the Match Reno, link is right there. Use code PC and Chill, PC and Chill 29 for the free 50-cent donation. We're currently sitting at $109.60. A lot of that kind of front loaded courtesy of Neo Celeste Gaming. Shout out to him for giving us a $100 pop bonus. If you want to do a direct donation, you can if you'd like, just like Neo Celeste Gaming has hooked us up with that $100 pop bonus. Check out the marketplace, Kite and Books for sale as well. But yeah, we are on and popping, like I said, about like 21 players within this bracket, lots of strong players, and a repeating theme from what we saw yesterday of like this 1 year anniversary tournament really attracting a kind of interesting variety of players as far as like Guzman's tournaments are concerned. You know, we see a lot of people that we recognize from the past and a lot of people that we recognize from more recent BB Tag and Chill tournaments. And we have a banger of a first match here. We're going to be having Bojack versus Duck.
So, I've actually never watched Bojack play at all, surprisingly, but I do know that he is a very popular Azrael player, but more recent times, in the more recent meta, he does swap to the Adachi Humor comp. It's a very, very strong, oppressive team comp. It kind of just makes you block something and force the mix, but on Duck Aider's side, we got his classic team, the Heart Akatsuki. So, it'll be kind of interesting to see how this matchup plays out.
Definitely. Round start, what do we got? Oh my god.
Duck went for a very ambitious round start of round start 2-3-6C. Not working out.
Oh my gosh, yeah, that's right now. Bojack just can't seem to make a wrong decision. Yeah, Akatsuki pairs are gonna be a big deal in this matchup as far as trying to escape some of the pressure Adachi Yumi is gonna be bringing to the table.
Confirming into a safe jump. Oh, probably expected a side swap there. Unfortunately, drops the combo. Doesn't bait the DP. Oh, excellent call on the active swap. Going to be killing this Yumi, actually. No, just barely doesn't.
Oh, man. I love the rerouting on the combo to make sure Yumi stayed in, not going for the full 5 BB. Just expected to beat Tatsu to kill and didn't spend another bar. And Akatsuki's going to be gone for it. Heartbreaker.
You know anything about Heart, this is definitely a viable comeback she could make. Doesn't bait the burst, unfortunately, but does actually whiff punish the 5B all up. So 1v1 situation, DP is baited. I don't know if this is going to be a kill. It's going to be very close, though.
Yeah, going to be spending the EX straight into the super. Lots of damage, not dead, but a lot of resonance wasted on Bojack's side.
Standard safe jump, hops over the Azio and zooms in for the punish, and just like that, Duck Aider will be taking game one of the set.
Very nice, good stuff to Duck, a solid start and a solid kind of recovery. You know, the kind of early seconds of that game were definitely a bit chaotic, going a lot in Bojack's favor, but yeah, again, that Akatsuki parry to kind of get out of those full screen block streams set up by like Yumi Snowbirds and BZO. Definitely, definitely going to come in clutch if you have the eye for it.
Mm-hmm, for sure. Last round start was a very interesting call. Duck decided to go for round start 2-3-6C. Didn't work out. Will he be optimistic once again and try to go for it? Let's see.
We shall see. Game two. Oh, okay. Got spin the meter pressure going.
So it's kind of hard to jump out of it. Going to be setting up in the heart corner. Oh, Bojack is just not deciding to block. Oh, that was almost really bad for Bojack, but nice back homing to punish the jump in.
Ooh. Wow, really going for some gamer routes there. Unfortunately, didn't have an ender.
Yeah, that's it by the 2B whiff. Not baiting a burst there either.
Yeah, that's
excellent 5B.
Yeah, that was a very good anti-air there from Duck. Yeah, one thing you really want to be careful about against Bojack's team is doing a bad burst, so definitely good on Duck recognizing the air raid was coming and bursting there. Usually a safe spot.
Yeah, the 4P will be hitting the Yumi, bringing her down. It's all up to Solo Dachi now.
Ooh! Heart air button just tearing through that Adachi JB. No bit confirmed, but still moving and grooving. Duck. Yeah, has the DP route this time, but no super ender!
Bojack giving another chance. Yeah, I think that's an AZU. Yeah, popping the resonance almost immediately, but gets hit low, but unfortunately, Drunk dropping the combo.
Oh. Okay. Yeah, gonna be getting something out of this resonance. You know, the command throw straight into the super. Heart is definitely taking a lot of damage. Oh, the crash on the 2B!
You can't anti-air Heart, that's illegal!
Dude, not only anti-airing heart in that way, and some of the big payoff just happened for Bojack. I don't want to call it robbery, but
it certainly looked pretty janky. Gets in the cross up JP, no full confirm, unfortunately. Duck will be popping errors into the 2C. Good parry call.
Ooh.
That conversion.
Yes, beautiful air stall with the persona there, baiting out the 5B from Duck. Pretty much evening up this matchup in terms of life totals. Duck still has the resonance available, but how much will that come into play? The up back on wake up, avoiding the throw, and Duck will still be able to take it. Going up 2-0 now.
Definitely a lot closer than Duck might have initially expected, but is able to just clutch it out in the end.
Yes, a bit of a scary run there. Bojack almost able to run it completely back with the solo Adachi, getting some very nice calls, some very blessed calls in terms of that 2B clashing, but it just wasn't quite enough to bring it all the way. And I mean, Duck, interestingly enough, is no stranger to Guzman Gaming Tournament, but I think this is their first PC Tag and Chill.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is their first PC Tag and Chill.
Yeah, it seems like Bojack is going to a different team entirely. You know, we're thinking maybe Azrael Adachi is something that we may see out of Bojack, but they're actually going to be going with Azrael Gord for the reverse sweep attempt.
Yeah. I will say, I do believe that Adachi is a really good MU for Heart, so maybe just wants to kind of like avoid that situation, not even trying to attempt to play the Adachi in this situation, just opting to go for the Gordo.
All right, as of right now, Duck is coming out swinging. Very nice round start scenario. Care to the corner. Bojack in a bit of trouble. That I don't know what happened.
So I think Bojack attempted to backdash assist in the corner, but Duck's JB was actually able to punish it. But
yeah, so this just seems to be getting rougher by the second here. Duck really capitalizing on a lot of big hits. Bojack just hasn't been able to... Wow, I like the attempt to anti-air command throw with Gord. It just was not the right trajectory at all.
Yeah, that was a really awkward situation, but it's all up to solo Azrael. But this is a good start. 5B starter. Going to be a huge amount of damage on this Akatsuki, but it's still going to be a tall mountain to climb.
Indeed. Oh, no!
So I don't know if that was supposed to be a combo or a reset, but either way, Duckator fell out and was just able to punish the Azrael DP, and he will be taking the set.
Yes, Duck will be going up 3-0. I do feel like maybe it was a air unblockable attempt. You know, Duck teched out of the corner, kind of avoiding that all entirely. So maybe if they neutral teched or back teched, it could have air reset. I'm not quite sure, but either way, Duck will be taking it in a... Yeah, definitely solid fashion. But yeah, a little bit of trivia. So like, as I was saying, Duck, that wasn't the first time that we've seen Duck here at Guzman Gaming. Twitch.tv/GuzmanGaming1 or BB Tag Chill, PC Tag and Chill Tournament. Just the first time we've seen that a PC Tag and Chill Tournament. Duck actually is tied with another individual for the most BB Tag and Chill wins, all right? And that's at 5. Duck has 5. There is another individual that also has 5 BB Tag and Chill wins. Do you want to guess who it is? chat? Lon? Anybody? Who's the other person that has 5 BB tag and chill wins?
Yo, 5 BB tag and chill wins? Huh. I wanna say, well, Flower Man?
Not quite. It's actually Dark Des. Dark Des is tied with Duck at 5 BB tag and chill wins. They have the most. Yeah, I did some digging. I just went through the entire archives of Guzman Gaming tournaments to get some interesting statistics. And yeah, that's what I came up with. Dark Des and Duck have the most BB tag and chill wins at 5.
Oh, nice, nice.
So yeah, it's good to see Duck on the PC tag train this time around. And speaking of PC tag plays, it looks like we're having quite the matchup come here next. We're going to be having Mustached Villain and Princess Essie, Mustached Villain. If you've just heard of the team Tager Teddy, then it has to be that you heard of Mustached Villain. Mustached Villain is definitely the Tager Teddy specialist and just has oodles and noodles of tech and wonky situations that they get going. It's really a pleasure of a player to watch all together.
Yeah, for sure. His team, or as I dub it, the circus, is he's got a lot of sauce with the team. He's definitely has labbed out a ton of situations, a lot of wacky, funny, and especially scary setups that if you're not ready for, you're definitely going to get smacked by this kind of like unicorn like clown team. You wouldn't expect to work as well as it does, but Mustache Villain has definitely put in the work to make it work. And hopefully we get to see some of that sauce today.
Absolutely. They're going to be going up against Princess Essie. We saw Princess Essie yesterday in BB Tag and Chill. I think they got 9th. They were like on the cusp of qualifying for Winterside Top 8. So from the Switch Tag universe, definitely strong player. Really interested to see how this matchup goes all together. Because again, this is one of those niche specialty teams. Mustache Villain is probably the only place that you're going to find this team. If you do find it elsewhere, I guarantee it may not be to the same potency and level of Mustache Villain.
Yeah, that's for certain. Princess Essie rocking with the classic team, the Narukami Elizabeth. It's definitely a very, very strong team with Viewpoint, just able to have that amazing lockdown pressure with Liz assist and amazing neutral as well with those assists.
Here we go to game one. Ooh, yeah, Bear Claw round start. It's an amazing move. Like, so fast, really hard to contest on round start.
Yeah, I believe that is an 8-frame special, so it actually beats a lot of round starts.
Indeed, indeed. Yeah, you can see Mustache Villain creating what you dubbed the circus of just like, you know, flying around with Teddy, calling these taker assists, and just being an all-around nuisance. Activates cross combo here. Yeah, this is rough.
Block force to burst in the Elizabeth to be set into this persona presser. Oh, interesting, swaps back into the Narukami.
Just okay.
For the cross raid.
Ooh. All right, yeah, combo gonna bring them back into the corner. Smart stuff here from Mustache Villain.
Yeah.
Really cheap.
That was. If he timed that right, that was, in fact, unblockable.
Oh, dear. Oh, wow.
That was also unblockable. That's the 43 frame unblockable. Oh, that was a really poor assist call versus Essie side just getting punished. The Liz will be going down. All up to Solok Narukami.
Yeah, Teddy with that jump A, the Twinkle Toes, just able to multi-hit box, get that Elizabeth out of here. Princess stuck to the solo Narukami to try to make something happen. It's been rough. The 2v2 game, again, Mustache Villain's team is so odd. It's such an oddball team to where, like, trying to figure out how you're going to approach it on the fly could be a bit of a task.
Yeah. There's a lot of cross-ups happening, but no full confirms. Doesn't confirm off the C0 hit.
Okay. No! Oh!
Mustache Villain! I know exactly what he was going for. You know, when he sees the kill ready, he just spams Spark Bolt for the kill. That's his haha funny ender. But my man's, he only had 2 meter.
Look, I thought we were going to see some meta combos of like, you know, double Spark Bolt, 5C can only, you know, hit a certain amount of frames in this time frame of like, but no, I think you're absolutely right. I think he may have thought he had 3 meters or just, you know, brain off, Spark Bolt punish, let's just do 3 of them. You only got stock for 2.
either way, the combo was dropped, but the game was not. So much special will be taking that one.
Absolutely. So yeah, we'll have to see how SE adapts around this. Because again, like, we definitely saw in terms of 2v2 game, it was definitely Mustache Villain dictated of like some good Spark Bolt calls and Tager 5P calls and the floating in there with Teddy. There's a lot to deal with at once when it comes to Mustache Villain's team. And like, not only that, you may find yourself in a position where you think you're safe, but like, you're not safe. Like, Mustache Villain will all of a sudden be like, oh, you're blocking? All right, I'm going to bear screw, set up a sandwich, good luck. Because it's like, you got to be really on point.
Sure, those Teddy items also dictate a lot of the neutral and just create a lot of chaos on screen. It can be very difficult to know what's going on. Oh, unfortunately, runs into the 5PP.
Yeah, this is big here for Princess. About 8k, yeah, no, close to 9k respectively on both ends here.
This Persona pressure is really getting the Mustache Villain. Sets up a Zeo and actually able to get a confirm out of it. This should be a kill on the Teddy at the very least.
Yes, beautiful stuff. Two happy birthdays, and boy, did they come in handy. Killing that Teddy off really early, just in the first 25 seconds of this game. Oh, and that's going to be a punish on the DP.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure that should be a punish. Tager's big hitbox is going to make that cross slash hit. And game two, very dominantly going to Princess.
Nice turnaround. Just picking those spots perfectly, kind of preventing the chaos from getting started in the first place and calling out when Mustache Rolls is going to be calling those assists out twice. Very, very solid stuff there from Princess. Yeah, we'll have to see how this carries on moving forward. I mean, Narukami is definitely one of those characters that you don't want to get happy birthdayed by or have your assist character hit by just because of Persona Displacement and the buttons that Narukami has in his kit. You can really kind of punish an assist character for like nothing, and then like if you're in block stun, it's going to be really hard to kind of interrupt him from doing so. So like, yeah, and a happy birthday as well, you know, very nice character, kind of stabilized happy birthdays with. So definitely got to be careful about those assist calls.
5AA will come in clutch when it comes to those happy birthday situations. Of course. Now,
like we practiced, ready? But yes, tied up 1-1, kind of back and forth momentum going on throughout the set altogether. See who is able to get to the two game up territory. Game three.
Goes for the burst start, red start. Gets the cross up Sparkle as well.
All right, yeah, corner positioning here for Mustache Villain. Items below, yeah, going for a route that would allow for them to get the positive item, leave the other one for Oki, good stuff.
Yeah, that baseball bat coming in clutch, it's just so ginormous, able to contest even Narukami 5A.
Yeah, and this is where things are getting kind of wild, because Mustache Villain has a very nice life lead. They're starting to get to the latter half of the Teddy items, which is where the chaotic stuff comes in. Look, we got the barrel below, Tager jump C.
Yeah, unfortunately, the barrel did not stabilize the combo, but an excellent Spark Bolt call to call out the assist call.
Oh, wow, the jump for Zeo. Yeah, she is in Awakening, so that Zeo is definitely quite nice during the double burst or double beam.
But she does have to be very careful. We'll be in the Watch Hush area. Princess actually playing very confidently with her on point. And yeah, imagine that was an active swap to get Narukami in.
Man, that was a beautiful conversion. We're talking like 8.8k, and I think that was all meterless.
Spent, but suddenly Narukami is also in the rear area, tries to call out something full screen with the Zeodine. Is that gonna be safe? Yes, actually.
Just barely. Called it a little bit late, but it still worked out. Oh, the DP able to punish!
Yeah, that is so unfortunate. Risky assist call coming around from Princess, gets hit by the
barrels!
The buckets coming in clutch. That is the last item on Teddy's rotation and easily his most dangerous one. It will just instantly win him neutral, and it's really hard to get out of once you started blocking it. So you always gotta listen for them. They have that really loud sound cue, but you gotta be prepared for them. You always gotta know when those are being chucked out. Unfortunately, Princess SE was not ready and just got killed because of it.
Yeah, for me, the PTSD is too strong. You know, when you see Teddy Just in general, cycle through a lot of their items, and like you're seeing like the lightning or the bomb kind of come through. You really want to keep an eye out for the buckets, because it's like the buckets are just kind of like this big thing. They're going to be coming out regardless. It's like a mini Chie Super, but you can't do anything about it. I mean, Chie Super in general is kind of hard to do anything about in the first place. But it's sneaky. There's no super flash, and really the only way you're going to know is, like you said, the sound cue, or just keep an eye on the items altogether. So Mustache Villain definitely seeing, yeah, both characters are low. If I just call this, if anything makes contact, they're going to die. Elizabeth saw. Yeah, Mustache Villain on game point here. Wild power. Here we go, game four.
My mic was off.
Oh, no worries.
Okay. Rouser 5A will be cashing out into deceased pressure. Going to be a nice, clean 9.1k.
Not bad, not bad. Yeah, Princess finding those happy birthdays that came in so clutch previously. Really getting a nice start on this matchup.
Oh, good 2B call, but unfortunately they couldn't confirm off it. Does not base the birth, though.
Ooh, the tick throw. The grappler brain cell coming into play. Okay.
Oh!
Wow, no belief off the IAD to kind of challenge Tager. Pushed him to the corner, though, overhead, nothing. Needs to be so careful. Happy birthday here for Mustache Villain.
Yeah, this is very huge. And if this stabilized, this should be a dead Narukami.
Oh,
unfortunately, it drops out. Very fortunate for Princess Essie. Give it another shot at life. Sets up the Hama, sets up the Mudo, but gets hit by the toy in the background. Oh, is that going to hit? The circus is here. The circus is here, folks.
Oh, what's that even hit on? Oh my. And Mustache Villain will be able to take it 3-1, bringing out all the toys and everything to come out and play. And man, that was definitely quite the set altogether. Man.
Yeah, I'll just say, I'm commentating. I got hit by that toy. I didn't even see that.
Yeah, it's funny because I liked Princess's idea to kind of set up things underneath Teddy to make sure that like Teddy was going to land into something and be kind of locked down. I thought that was a very smart idea. It's just given the items that Mustache Villain threw out there, like that rocket at the bottom just kind of blew up everything that Princess Essie had set up there. Because it was the right presence of mind. It just did not work out at all.
Looks like we'll be having EX Zeo versus Potion up next.
Very cool. So yeah, EX Zeo, the Narukami Elizabeth comp is not something that we haven't seen before here at Peace, Attack, and Chill. EX Zeo is one of the regulars of the past. Like, EX Zeo was a player that I feel like I saw a lot in like the early Peace, Attack, and Chills. So it's nice to see them back for the 1 year anniversary edition. Gonna be going up against Potion here, which is the previous Peace, Attack, and Chill winner. So yeah, there's definitely been a nice influx of Switch Attack players for these PC Tag and Chill brackets. And so it'll definitely be an interesting matchup altogether. This is a PC Tag and Chill past versus PC Tag and Chill present matchup here.
Yeah, both of them locking into their Elizabeth teams currently, it looks like.
Seems so. Yeah, I know Potion has Chi, Elizabeth. There's a couple of other side teams they have. I want to say Celica Kanji, if I'm not mistaken. I may be wrong on that, though.
I wouldn't be able to tell you. I am unfortunately not too well-versed on the Switch Tag player repertoire of teams, unfortunately.
Look, they're gamers. That's one community that I got to get a little bit closer with and learn a little bit more about over Guzman's absence is the Switch Tag community, and they definitely have some interesting players, strong players as well, players that I'd like to see more crossover with like PC Tag and PS4 player bases. So really hyped to see a couple of them in this bracket. And like we said, Potion, like all the Farm Switch Tag player base, won the last PC Tag and Chill. So definitely interested to see how this one goes.
Yes. This would be an interesting match. Lend me your strength.
Funny that, like, does every Narukami Elizabeth player just play the same colors as well? Because this is the same color scheme that Princess had here for EX Zeo.
I'm just saying, who wouldn't? The Velvet Room colors are dope.
True, true.
Ballsy round start counter working out, unfortunately getting hit by the Liz 6P. I don't know what just happened. Drop combos everywhere. Persona's being broken everywhere. The meteor is coming out. EX Zeo unfortunately falling into it.
Whew. Yeah, a little bit of scrambles. A lot of it going in Potion's favor thus far. Oh, big jump in.
On the Hama there was not a good time to set it up, going to be set in this corner situation, but interesting text out, but Liz DP being cursed as always, and this might be a kill. Yeah, I think that second bar is being built. Ghastly Whale, the other Elizabeth, get that fake out of here.
Yeah, that was so rough as Elizabeth just going for that DP and like seeing it get punished with the Chie dash punch B version, no less. I knew that was gonna be a dead Elizabeth off rip. Yo, curse clashes.
Yeah, GA still in the pressure. The push block will be falling out, but she is really low. I think that's a Margaru. Oh, unfortunately, since that's counter hit, she is able to confirm off it, but no full conversion.
Yeah, that was a really smart idea. Just not able to get the kill on EXEO, but some nice positioning, you know, making... Oh my gosh, yeah, it's stuck in block stun forever. Beautiful stuff there from Koshin, taking game one.
That GA Sato Naka pressure could be extremely hard to get out of, especially with that unpushblockable JC. On top of that unpushblockable JC, she gets some really nasty IED mix. It can be really, really tough to get out of.
Big facts. Yeah, something that's interesting about Potion's team is like the ways that this team can create out stupid amounts of block stun. Like GA's jump C on Oki, especially in the corner, is something that's really obnoxious to kind of try to deal with, especially off of like a 2C ender, no less. But it's not even necessary, right? You can cover so many types of techs with just a simple GA jump C, but like having Elizabeth behind you to where you can even maybe call in a 6P or 5P for even more lockdown, it's a very interesting team.
Yeah, for sure. It's basically a team where it's like, oh, you blocked my first mid? Here, have three more.
Yes. Sure, all right, let's see how this works out. Game two.
Oh, that is so unfortunate. Unfortunately, isn't able to stabilize the combo, but just gets hit. I don't know what she's doing on this side, but that was a lot of stuff going on. But JC not gonna punish it, just going in with the EXO car. Oh my god, that was so sneaky, but unfortunately trust the combo.
Oh my gosh, this has been such a hard match to kind of call. I mean, Potion, there's been a couple of drops, but constant decision making, and a lot of it has just been right. I mean, look at EXO's health bar. Like, there hasn't really been any like super, super big combos, but like even throughout the resets and just keeping the pressure going, Potion is getting heavily rewarded for it.
Yeah, okay. Liz DP will be actually working out. This time, able to get the backswing. Is the Meteor's going to be punishing it? Yeah.
That was such a smart interruption. You know, the full screen Meteor's a very low risk call out that paid off in dividends. You know, getting a dead Elizabeth on EXEO side back to this familiar situation. Solo Dark. Yo! What?
I don't know what just happened. That was sick.
That was crazy. It was like the last hitbox of Elizabeth's 5A. To hit from that was so nuts.
This entire match is just goes in with the JC and Potion able to just win game two. That entire Narukami residence was wild.
Yeah, that was masterful timing, being able to confirm off of Elizabeth's 5A hitting that way. That's one of like the bad things of the move. It seems like it's such an amazing move because you see Elizabeth 5A in your mind, you want to equate it with Yumi 5B, but no, it's not quite like that. But like, it's a multi-hit, you know, kind of retreating button that like, if it hits shallow, it can be really, really hard to confirm off of or really kind of do anything or even notice that it's happening. So for Potion to be like ready and have the TA 6P ready to go and get almost full combo conversion off of that, that was really nice.
Shows a lot of the comfortability with the character and the team. But EXEO, interesting swaps off into the Labrys Narukami. This is, I believe, his side team. Still rocking with those Velvet Room colors, though.
Indeed, indeed. No Josie Labrys. There we go, game three.
Just gets a bad CP round start, but unfortunately drops the combo.
Oh, that GA jump C coming in so clutch offensively and defensively.
Greatest mix, the 5C coming in, winning put into the corner. Just gonna be DPing out of it.
Alright, this is nice. That axe is building. Okay, able to find an opportunity to burst, bring this Elizabeth in command throw, baby.
Yeah. Azio bursting out in turn, trying to save that Labrys, but excellent call with the Zeodine!
Yeah, that was fantastic from EXE. Oh! Convert!
Let's go.
Beautiful. Narukami privileges.
Hell yeah, all up to solo Elizabeth, but that move is plus?
I guess so.
Oh, goes for the air reset too. EXE falling for it. Just gonna be cashing out into the ghastly whale to just avoid any burst potential.
Woo! Yeah, oh. From the air unblockable off that EXE on point right now. For yeah. Sandwich. Oh! See, I was a little concerned that something like that may have happened. I was wondering if the EXE was gonna double jump, which would have covered a lot of options. It would have covered DP and that reversal super, but unfortunately did not. 1v1 situation.
Versus potion. Or Labyrinth, not potion. God. Oh yeah, that is minus, but just sniffing out with a DP. Gotta be careful of the astral though.
Yes, potion recognizing it, just getting out of dodge. EXE has a lot of bar to work with though. Ooh, what a DP interruption on the block string.
I wasn't even sure that DP was coming out.
Ooh. Yo, the nooch. Oh, there it is. EXE finding the hit, getting the confirm, and we'll be getting their first game on the board. Does Labyrinth swap work it out?
Definitely feel like Labyrinth is maybe a bit more better suited than compared to going with the Elizabeth mirror, because her JB is really big, so it is able to kind of like hit Elizabeth assist a lot better than like Lizard herself can, just to kind of stop a lot of what Potion wants to do on offense.
Absolutely. But yeah, Potion almost able to bring it back with the solo Liz, not for nothing. That isn't the easiest thing in the world to do. But EXEO stand on top of it. See if they're able to, maintain this kind of momentum that they have going on here.
We shall see.
Let me show you what I've got. Yeah, I am a fan of the switching to Labyrinth for personal reasons. There was like so many interactions where two Elizabeths were on the screen doing an assist, and Elizabeth lingers for so long, and I'm just like, wait, who's this who again?
Definitely get very confusing, especially since EXEO has got the Velvet Room colors.
Yes. Oh my gosh, red axe. No Ender though. Yeah, that's big. The Oki was a little bit worse. It could have been a potion under some big pressure. Now things are getting turned around. Chie is getting started.
Yeah, and the burst will be punished by the assist. No like full conversion to like make this a kill situation, but this corner pressure is terrifying. But nice block on the 5C.
Yeah, that was fantastic. In fact, I think EXE was actually up backing to kind of nullify that mix a little bit. Ooh, that it was a counter hit, so wasn't going to be able to get the full hit stun there.
Just getting tapped low, but this Chie is looking really low. I don't think that's going to be a kill. Both characters really...
Oh my gosh!
Oh, you... excellent conversion!
Jump C and assist! You love to see it, but EXE, your Narukami is so low, you're giving me anxiety! What? Oh. What is for it? Oh my gosh!
The anti-air 214B coming out, still calling this assist! Really ballsy, activates the resonance on the Garu!
Alright, look, I'm gonna have high blood pressure by the end of this match if you call that Narukami one more time. Getting the air DP bait, this is big here for EXE.
I think if there's no drops, there's still gonna be a kill, but unfortunately the drop happened with the 6B coming in clutch and EXE able to take game 4, giving both of us a heart attack.
Jeez, this is just too much to handle. But yeah, EXE has really found something here with this Labyrinth swap. A lot of things are working out. The only thing that we aren't seeing are some combo enders that are just, yeah, creating a lot of anxiety, but EXE just staying on top of it. They've really tied it up 2-2, working on this reverse sweep.
Looks like Potion will be sticking with the Chie Elizabeth. I definitely don't feel like the team is doing anything particularly wrong. I just think EXE is just handling his offense better in those situations compared to Potion, just able to snipe out the assist and just get those raw hits on Chie.
Yes, indeed. Well, Game 5, this really feels like it can go either way. This tug of war between, again, PC Tag and Chill of the past, PC Tag and Chill of the present. Man, this is hype.
That's for sure.
Real Game 5.
Oh, goes for the wrestler might be. Okay, thankfully, Labrys fell out of the combo. That could have actually just been straight up dead characters, but that JB coming in clutch.
Yeah, off of that interruption on the happy birthday when Labrys fell out, if EXO went for EX Chain Knuckle instead and got that projectile invul, I think that would have been a happy birthday.
Oh, I think that was a Chain Knuckle attempt. Unfortunately, the Meteors will be punishing that. All up, it's a solo Nara coming now. This is going to be a tough mountain to climb, but that 5B starter certainly is not helping.
That potion got started and has not stopped, and oh, this is spinning that cash. Definitely going to be game. And there it is. Potion able to take it 3-2 over EXZEO in what was a super tight set. But Potion able to stabilize and come out on top. Very, very solid stuff. It's truly impressive. For sure. I think I might be falling in love. Yeah, that was definitely something else. You know, EXZEO tried to dig deep at that Labyrinth. Definitely switched up the pacing of the matchup quite a bit. And almost able to make that reverse sweep comeback, but Potion is proving a bit too powerful for now as they will be staying in winner side. And all these matches on stream and the tournament altogether has definitely been a roller coaster. Really, really fun, really, really exciting. Hope that you guys are all enjoying here on this Saturday, PC Tag and Show number 29 here at twitch.tv/GuzmanGaming1. If you have not already, please be sure to use that code PC and Chill 29 for a free 50-cent donation in the match arena. We're currently sitting at $110.10. A lot of that front loaded from NeoCelest Gaming. Thank you for that $100 pop bonus that has gone towards this bracket and the bracket yesterday on PS4. So if you haven't already, please use that code. Direct donations are also available if you'd like, and check out the marketplace. You know, Kitan Books has some cool books for sale if you want to purchase one of those as well. But this next match that we have, Lon, have you seen these two players ever play before? Like, I feel like this is the first time meeting, right?
This is most definitely the first time meeting. You know, that's from David is a classic Nintendo 64 player, while E2 Deku is a bit more modern, playing on the Nintendo Wii U. So, you know, clash of two titans on their respective platforms. But no, we're just trolling you. This right here is the classic, the PC Tag and Chill of the past Grand Finals every single week. This is what you would be seeing, folks. That Scrub David on the Hazama Adachi, E2 Deku on the Yang Ruby. Always exciting to see these two players duke it out. It just reminds me of the good old times back in 2020.
Indeed. Yeah, Grand Finals, even before Grand Finals, I should have pulled a stat of how many times these two have played in bracket here at this tournament, because I think it's at least 10. Like, they have played a lot.
Oh yeah, goes for the reset. That has been something E2 Deku has been implementing a lot more lately. This Azama is getting beat up, has to be very careful. Sets up a sandwich situation, but the most blessed 5B in the world coming in clutch isn't able to seal out the deal on the Azama, but the firecracker will.
Oh yeah, that was not, yeah, Yang got hit, so that command throw not making contact. E2 Deku on fire in this matchup so far.
Set into the corner, yeah, activates the resonance to avoid the command grab, but unfortunately that is not the best movement option in that situation, and that Scrub David's Adachi should be going down.
Fantastic stuff. E2 Deku starting off so strong here, really got a commanding lead and just carried it all the way to the end. And that is something that interesting to note, that air tech reset with the Yang command throw is something that E2 Deku has kind of opted for a bit recently. It's really kind of made their Oki game in the corner with Yang a bit more terrifying, because like the way out of it, I believe, is dependent on the way that you tech, but then E2 Deku even has layers outside of that of like depending on when they call Ruby Assist to set up even more sandwiches, it just like won't even skip from the mix even if you know it's coming.
It's something I've only had to be at the end of a couple times, but I'll tell you what, when it does hit me, I'm like, man, that was dirty.
Yes. So here we go, jumping into game two, see if that Scrub David is able to recover.
Yeah. Okay, able to jump out of the sandwich situation and gets the air button in. Going to be nullifying the CC and putting that Scrub David in the corner.
Oh my gosh.
Whoa. No one would be ready for that.
Whew. Solid defense, solid defense from E2 Deku in the entire that situation.
Indeed. Not getting hit by anything huge, and just as soon as I say that, gets hit by the JA, isn't able to bait the burst, but gets hit by the 4P.
Ooh. Nice dash throw here from Natch Grub David to get things started, carrying to the corner. Yeah, definitely needs to block right out of the okay. Blockable, that was so cheap!
Oh,
this is nuts.
Ruby is being called out constantly, but she is really low, has to be extremely careful. Still just calling her out, gets the grab though, goes for a reset, but that's from David, ready for it!
Oh no!
This is so unfortunate for that Scrub. David just made himself go to the happy birthday all up. The solo Adachi activating the resonance immediate, tries the mash out, but E2 Deku ready for that meaty, and this might be a kill if we can extend the combo for long enough.
Oh yeah, absolutely, we'll be able to. These two just do a lot of damage, very good conversion potential into each other, so E2 Deku getting the resonance supers, and we'll be able to have it work out. That was such an unfortunate situation there for David, because like, in their head, in that situation, Yang being above and Hanzama being punished, I feel like they knew the jump seat was coming, but like the way that it was positioned, I think it was a bit awkward that they didn't know which way they were going to have to block. So being Adachi, I guess the mindset was like, do I DP? Do I rely on like my lackluster 2B? Or maybe do I just block it? And then like by the time they were like cycling through that decision making in their head, it was too late. And boy, was the payoff great for E2 Deku.
Yeah, that was an unfortunate situation for that script, David.
Yes. So, interesting. So this is that Scrub David's first match of the day. All right. If you're familiar with PC Tag and Chill lore, that Scrub David has won quite a few PC Tag and Chill tournaments. But the that Scrub David Classic is losing round one and then making the losers run for their life. So like, it's kind of canon. At this point, if E2 Deku gets the 3-0 of like seeing the Dab Script David sweep, like that would really be the proper way to have the 1 year anniversary go out. But I don't know, maybe it's new year, new me. Dab Script David's gonna try to go against that. We'll have to see.
Oh, just getting hit by the raw 6P. That's from David confirming into a nice little combo here. A lot of patient play in the neutral, just Sis being called out. That's from David trying to catch this Yang. Oh, gets a hit overhead! Yeah, made the burst that time.
Ooh, the push block? Yeah, just trying to avoid that mix altogether.
Unfortunately, Yang 6P not working out, but why is she in that corner?
Oh my gosh, yeah, the raw buzzsaw not able to make contact with Adachi. Well, this neutral is out of control right now.
Yeah. David setting up the BZO pressure obstacle for Grand Grab, but nice jump out.
BZO.
Oh, excellent float over the AZO just to punish it, but unfortunately drops the combo.
Wow, went for a tick throw, but a little bit too plus. Gotta be punished here from Natch Grub David, who was attempting the tech, but getting rewarded for it regardless.
Oh, that's a button coming out. Is that gonna get car canceled? Nope. And that Scrub David will be taking out the Yang, no burning ear.
So smart post semblance to get a like screen freeze of their own with that cross combo to see what E2 Deku is going to be doing. Very smart there from that Scrub David.
That was a nasty little unblockable setup. Sets up the PZO, yeah, just using it to safely swipe back into the Zama.
Ooh. Double low, nothing. Oh, for sandwich, and yeah, that's gonna be it. That's where David will be getting their first game on board against E2 Deku.
Sorry, but would you mind taking this fight?
Yeah, that's where David definitely looking a bit more solid this time around for that match with their backup against the wall. Liking the chain plus 6P, the classic. You know, it's really such a strong kind of like, if you're enabled to get it going in the neutral, it's really a strong tool that's super hard to contend with for a lot of characters of having those two nice hitboxes on screen and being able to convert off of it no matter what hits is a really, really nice asset to have. Yeah, that's good. David definitely still has some work to do, you know? A third of the way toward the full reverse sweep. I'm wondering if we're getting PC tagged at the moment.
You're either getting PC tagged or someone hasn't pressed A yet. Or both, you know.
Not quite sure. I'm getting a bit nervous. What does stream look like? Yeah, we're all here. What happened?
PC. I think usually when this happens, it just means someone hasn't pressed A yet, and I see Chop Suey. Well, I'm assuming it's Chop Suey because it's Izioi GA in the room, and maybe they're just AFK and haven't pressed A yet.
If it all worked out.
Yeah. Going to be getting on to this game 4 now.
Let's raise a little hell. Joker we? Colors for Magic of David as always.
That's practically my job at this point.
Well, Ruby, you classics on Itsu Deku side. Of course, can't go wrong with the defaults.
True, true. Can't escape from crossing fate. Alrighty, game 4. Both kind of retreating. Ooh. Ah, oh, man, didn't get a punish on that burst. Oh, Ruby didn't even allow for the confirm, even though we're on the opposite end.
James plus 6B sets up a sandwich situation, does not block the overhead. Nice conversion.
Okay. Yeah, Yang kind of low in Semblance territory, though. David needs to be a little bit careful what they, like, pressure with, because Chip can bring Yang into Semblance, which may create some chaos.
Yeah, and speaking of Semblance, okay, not going to be activating right now. Good air stall kind of making tricky, but Itsu Deku staying solid on the defense.
Whew.
That was actually a really interesting use of Persona Displacement.
Indeed, indeed. Oh, oh wow.
Intellect.
Still working out here for that scrub. David really been dictating a lot of the pace here. Itsu Deku has not been able to find a way to get started.
Yeah, but excellent match on the command grab, but not believing in that combo. That's up another sandwich scenario. Itsu Deku's got to be really careful on the defense, and the defense was active swap.
Yeah, this won't be a dead Yang, though. She's still alive, and she will be burning.
Yeah. Oh, smacking the Itachi, but yeah, that move does have armor, just able to go straight through it.
Oh, wow, didn't jump. The active swap from David, chain plus 6P. Oh, but the cross up is what seals the deal here for Yang, solo Ruby here for Itsu Deku. Oh,
just,
yeah. Man.
Oh, what? What? Ruby is a privileged character. You can't convince me.
What?
What?
They both DP and they both whiff. Like, I don't think it was like they both to each other. I think they actually both whiff.
I legitimately think that Hazama just... I don't know. Okay, that was a frame trap. That made sense. That was a very PC tag round in the sense that it was really cursed.
Absolutely. I'm like, so... I mean, I guess on that scrub, David, then on the Oki going for DP, you know, it just shows the invulnerable action. But for Itsu Deku to go for the meaty DP, that was definitely something else. I don't know. Maybe if they were a bit closer, it might have even worked. It's hard to say. Get
ready. Yeah, that was a situation.
All right, well, that script David is still firing back here. We're tied up 2-2. This is can truly go either way now.
It's a clash of the PC tag titans of old will soon be coming to an end. Which one of them comes out on top, we will have to see.
Well, Ruby, you having fun yet?
Yes, yes, we shall see. Game 5 situation here. Can Itsu Deku find some footing? Because, I mean, like, really, that's what David has been able to get their game plan going now, and since, like, Itsu Deku's been struggling, trying to use armor as the answer.
That's it low, but the burst is baited on time, going to be set in this corner.
That's the ender, safe jump.
Oh, empty jump, nothing, 5C. What a gamer.
Beautiful. Oh, air unblockable? Yep.
Did it a bit too late, so isn't able to get a full confirm on, gets the 2C counter, but no really big combo.
Yeah, man, this is unfortunate for Itsu Deku. They just haven't been able to stop that scrub David from getting started. And when that scrub David gets started, they just haven't been able to stop him. Like. Whoa!
Oh, Fortunes of the Yang 6B being cursed. That's Group David mashing out with the 5B, and it's all up to Solo Yang now. Will be put in the semblance.
Yeah, activating Resonance now. Great defense thus far. You're going to need a lot more of that.
Unfortunately, drops the combo. Oh, that does not a combo.
This can be the something bad if your name is at Scrub David. Fortunately for them, E2 Deku drops the combo. Resonance being nullified now. Smart on David to just go on a retreat to try to prevent any further chaos. The throw on the ground from the strike throw mix. And that's Scrub David will be taking it 3-2 over E2 Deku.
Yeah. There was a lot of unfortunate drops, lots of spaghetti getting thrown around, but Astro David will be moving on to the next round.
Nice, nice, good stuff to David. Like I said, new year, new David. No being sent to losers first round and then making the comeback of a lifetime. That's the old me. That's the old David. David, Forma Day 2021, we stay in winner side, and he'll be doing just that, going on to face Zero Shadow Blood.
Yes, and I believe up on deck next we will be having Chop Suey it's a very fancy way of saying versus. Versus Chop Suey, which is a kind of an interesting fight we're having on PC tag of all things, because these two are definitely no strangers to PS4 tag, but here they are, just hopping up on the PC. I knew that Duck had PC tag, but I actually didn't know that Chop Suey had PC tag.
Yeah, so Chop Suey came in second for BB Tag and Chill yesterday, it seems like they used their earnings to buy PC tag. They were on the fence about it, wanted to know if they could run it, and it seems like everything's going so far so good. They're still in the bracket, so yeah, Chop Suey, this is like their first day of PC tag, and they're using it to play in PC Tag and Chill.
First day of PC tag doesn't mean the first day of BB tag. These are definitely two veteran seasoned players with a lot of excellent placing, so this will be a good match for sure.
Yes, this is a winner side top 8 qualifying match, so winner of this will be moving on to that winner side top 8 spot to actually fight for Sir Kirby, who also qualified with a 3-2 win over Jurassic Jack. But here we go, game one.
Feels like the game is running at like 30 FPS. Is that just me?
Possibly. It seems like things are a bit odd.
Yeah, this map. Maybe they need a stage switch because this map is definitely
it's the stage.
Yeah.
At them, let them know this is PC tag. Cannot start. Let's see.
Yeah, that.
Okay, cool, cool. Yeah, Ruby stage. I also think that, like, my personal favorite is, like, basically any uni stage. Definitely Riverside Space is the gold reliable. But yeah, we'll get that stage swap popping. We'll see. These two have had to have played in the past in like BB Tag and Chills. I'm not sure who usually comes out on top, but I imagine that they do have some type of matchup knowledge against each other. Definitely one thing that'll be interesting is kind of like the air game between the two. I mean, we definitely know that Chop Suey has access to that air game with the easy way. Being able to float, call those Chi-A6P assists, and just be kind of a hard, you know, opponent to catch. They can even do it on the flip end, you know, if they have Chie in, you know, those jump season meteors following up with like Easy Way 6Ps. And basically, it's just like the way that you could call Easy Way 6P on this team is just like, I'm gonna throw this out, and if you block this, it's your fault, right? And then get your mix started from there. So,
yeah, I will say, I've had Scrub has been on the practicing the Easy Way, and I've actually gotten to use Heart against his Easy Way, and I gotta say, surprisingly enough. The thing about Hard is like it's really hard to anti-air just because of how floaty she is and how easy it is for her to dodge a lot of the anti-airs coming in. But surprisingly, EZOI 214B covers a good amount of space and is able to kind of like sometimes catch Heart if she's kind of just zooming in on you and isn't really in that position to, like, make it awkward for her to block. And, like, I just learned this, but apparently that 214B also has, like, 4-frame head invul. So it can also be, like, pretty good defensively as well. It's gonna be a surprisingly interesting matchup.
Diafiniet Lee. But yeah, it seems like they have joined, have the stages swap. Hopefully it makes a difference, because yeah, that first match definitely looked a little odd. Ready, ready.
Game one, former to game two.
Yeah, so we are on the Riverside space. The loading definitely looks smoother.
The justice I believe in is my own.
All right, could it be game one? Frilzy.
Oh, we play on the GBA now.
Yes.
Oh. Ooh. Yeah, that ain't. That ain't looking so hot.
Yeah, I imagine it's a problem with frame drops. It can't be a connection problem. I think these two are both East Coast, but yeah, we'll see. They're going to try it upstream just to see what's going on.
Okay, so we'll be having a different match.
Yeah. You know, look, Guzman, I'm taking matters into my own hands just in case. I'm going to remake the lobby. I'm sorry, executive decision. I don't make the rules until I make the rules. So I'm remaking the basic password.
It's not under Atkins' authority until it is.
Look, I don't have any scientific proof of remaking the lobby doing anything. I just felt like it needed to be done. All right, PC tag, I don't trust it. So we're just remaking the lobby just in case.
Yeah. It's like turning it off and on. Like turning your computer off and on, you know?
Indeed, indeed. But yeah, we'll have to see who we're having coming up to stream. I do see a Scrubbers. Yeah.
Looks like our match will be the old fave Scrub versus Potion. Yeah. Definitely would be inclined to believe that these two have not fought in the past before, considering that Potion is a primarily Switch type player, and Yo Fave Scrub, he hops between PS4 and PC tag. But I definitely haven't seen this match before, so this would be interesting to see if Potion is able to keep up with the Yo Fave Scrub aggression. He does play very aggressive. Is he on Easy Oi?
Oh yeah, he's still on Easy Oi.
I was gonna make a comment about how it might be difficult for his team to kind of have to deal with both Ragna and Ruby Buttons, considering they're quite large and, you know, quite active, and it can be kind of hard to, like, get those proper assist call in. But no, the Astro David is logging in the team that I like to call "Please get me out of here," because my God, is that Easy Oi 6B have so much blocks done, and the pressure with this team is really insane. Though Strub has only been with this team for a week, so kind of interesting to see him roll it up for the tournament.
Definitely, we shall see. Potion getting the better of the Strong Star here, bursting an early burst out of Scrub. Ooh, strike throw, and I don't think Scrub was quite expecting it. You know, anticipating that Izzy Oi, or sorry, Elizabeth 6P.
Yeah, there's options over DP. More DP.
Right back at you. Oh, and they are really just kind of vying for pressure here. Oh, very nice air stall baiting out that Liz DP. Potion kind of on the aggressive here. Yeah, they nothing too big on either side. They're really just kind of trading blows, but with some smart decision making on defense to make sure nothing's too explosive.
Yeah, well, goes for the maybe expecting a gauntlet. Hey, yeah, that is jump cancel.
Yeah, that was not the point to block if your potion, especially if I have bars on deck here for Scrub, is going to be very threatening.
That might actually be a kill if he fishes for- Oh, unfortunately drops out of the combo!
Oh, very nice stalls to get rid of these Elizabeth DPs here from Scrub. Oh, the active swap, and that will be game one going to Scrub. But yeah, definitely some solid stuff. Again, early game was definitely kind of up in the air. Both of these two making some clutch decisions in the defense on in terms of their DPs and their burst. But Scrub was just kind of able to get started and got some solid reach from there. You know, really air stalling, which was something I think it was the EXZEO match of like when you're airborne against Elizabeth and like coming down, you kind of want to force her to have to use or like rely on 2B. Because like it's her anti-air is okay, but like really if you could have her rely on that and whiff and then having to get between throw and DP, double jump will beat a lot of her like anti-air options or just like her kind of options on the air to ground game in general.
Yeah. That 2B is not the most reliable anti-air, so it is able to just easily bait it out like that.
Oh, what a round start to reverse hit Ragna jump A, and Izzyoi helping out Ragna to open up in the front. This is rough if you're poaching right now.
Yeah, opts to go for a mash. No bait out, just willing to kill. Oh, okay.
Look, I had a feeling that we were going to be adding another phone to the collection here for Yo Fave Scrubs, but I mean, even if there's no phone, it's still a rough situation if you're poaching. This Chia is down so early.
Quite literally full health characters, going to be forced into this scary pressure. Nice block so far! Keeping calm on the defense, just able to find an opportunity to get out, but yeah, that is DPable on reaction. Gets hit low, and this is looking like a perfect.
A perfect it looks like, and a perfect it is here for Yo Fave Scrub as they are getting game two. Just solid stuff. Really, the round start is what dictated a lot of the pacing of that matchup, because Potion did not... stuffing that out in the way that they did, Scrub, like, Potion didn't have a burst available, so they just had to hold all that mix to the face, right? And it's really ugly mix with Izzyoi 6P, Gauntlet Hades 2C, side swaps, you know, all the whole nine yards, right? And so definitely kind of a rough call here for Potion as they are switching entirely. Going to be going to Yosuke Narukami, actually.
Yeah.
But yes, we shall see if this swap works out here for Potion. I mean, in terms of the matchup, it's definitely going to kind of switch things up a bit. You know, Yosuke and Arakami is a solid team in its own right, but they're going to have access to a lot more air mobility and possibly some lockdown if they're able to get started. They still got to navigate past Scrub. Scrub has been a complete menace in this matchup thus far.
So that air-to-air conversion is definitely a good start. Nice block on the cross-up.
Yeah, push blocking, trying to deter against a cross combo or sandwich situation. That Izzyoi 6P still active, stuffing out Narukami. Unfortunate there for Potion.
Unfortunately drops the ender of that combo. Oh, excellent runners on the V-slash.
I can't believe that. That was so good. Reverse hit JB. Oh, no. Garudai in reverse with the DBD. Look at all the damage done. The life regain. You're back to square one, except it's square negative one. You don't have a character. This is rough if you're potion.
Yeah, so Narukami is definitely a good solo character, but it's two almost full health characters. And as soon as I say that, suddenly that Ragday looking so hot.
Yeah, Scrub was teching forward hitting buttons so much on Narukami of all characters. Like,
yeah. Suddenly this huge life deficit, it doesn't look so huge. Yeah, that was a bit too far away to really convert off. Gets the DP read, unfortunately does not get tech chase. A lot of raw hits just going around. DP the DP! And suddenly Potion has made this a 1v1 situation.
Alright, but this is Ragna. Ragna does have 25k health, and that's purely just because of the life steal. In Resonance, it gets even more meme-y.
Oh, what's the move? Oh, goes to the raw DP! Going to not get as much life as possible, just opting to go for some damage.
Yikes!
Oh, I don't know if that's going to be a dead character, but it's gonna be close. I don't think so.
Yeah, but still some life still. Look at this Ragna, nearly a full health of me. 5A and Yo Face Scrub. with the Ragna, we'll be able to take it 3-0 over Potion and move on into top 8 territory. It takes its true form when justice must be done. Yeah, solid match there for Scrub all together on the Ragna Easy Way. Not even having to bring out the Ragna Ruby quite yet. And yeah, they will be in top 8 here at Peace Attack and Chill number 29, 1 year anniversary edition. It looks like for the next match, we will be figuring out their opponent, where it looks like we will have Zero Shadow Blood versus That Scrub David. Definitely Zero Shadow Blood's first PC Tag and Chill as well. Recently being able to fix like their PC Tag copy. I think they were having some controller issues that Rialza was able to help out with. So nice to see them in the land of the PC Tag for a matchup that has probably never happened. I don't think these two have played each other before.
Yeah, I've definitely never seen this match.
But yes, should be sick as we are winding down in this bracket, folks. I hope that you guys have all been enjoying it thus far. If you have, hey, show some love. We got a, did I spell it wrong? No, Nightbot is just slow. Nightbot, wake up. We're doing a Matcharino show, all right? Use that code PCandChill29 for the free 50-cent donation if you haven't already. We're currently sitting at $110.10, although that's a pretty cool number. It could be higher, so be sure to use that code PCandChill29 for the free 50-cent donation. Shout outs as always to Neosless Gaming for the direct donation of $100 to boost us up to this point. Yusoro, I think, also did a direct donation. I see you. Thank you for that. If you want to do a direct donation like Neosless Gaming and Yusoro have, feel free to donate to the pot as well. And check out the marketplace. You know, Kaiten Books has some nice books for sale. You scoop one of those copies up. But again, PC and Chill 29 for the free donation. It just takes about 20 seconds, you know?
Quick, easy, and all our players would definitely appreciate that tiny little bonus to the pod.
Yes, yes, but yeah, this is gonna be something else. Zero Shadow Blood versus That Scrub David. Zero Shadow Blood is someone that we're definitely familiar with a lot. I mean, the player base as a whole may be familiar with, in terms of Guzman's tournaments for like ladder BB Tag and Chills. I think they won one recently, and they've been entering a few recently in terms of yesterday's BB Tag and Chill 1 year anniversary. Zero Shadow Blood placed third. And That Scrub David, PC Tag and Chill vet, you know, from the beginning, has been here for like quite a bit of time. So definitely some seasoned and decorated players that we have going on here, but seeing them clash for the first time is definitely going to be exciting.
That's for sure.
Yeah, also maybe a bit interesting in terms of the matchup. Hazama, not too popular of a character nowadays. Adachi Hazama being one of those teams for Hazama in 2.0 that is very, very strong. But I actually, and I may be forgetting someone here, but I don't know of any Adachi Hazama players on PS4 tag. If I'm not mistaken, there may be some. If I'm forgetting someone, I'm sorry. But we do have Waffle on Susanoo Yumi and PC tagland, so.
How much MU knowledge they have. Oh, unfortunately, drops a little combo, but yeah, I imagine that Susanoo 4P is going to be dictating a lot of the neutral here, especially considering how airborne Hazama is.
Force sandwich situation. This is reference to That Scrub David. Ooh, yeah, that's going to be all unburstable here. No burst available for That Scrub David, only for spin two bars. Zero Shadow Blood getting a kill.
Yeah, and we're seeing the name of the game for Zero Shadow Blood team. Touch you once, suddenly you're dead. Puts up another sandwich situation, sets up the Grand Viper, but finds an excellent place to block.
Oh, nice confirm off the overhead going straight to the super, but no 2C pickup. That was pivotal there for That Scrub David. I don't know if it's going to be a dead human, but it's going to be really close.
Yes, that's for sure, but able to get the whiff to be punished. Just going to be cashing out. Do a lot more damage, goes for another reset, but that 4P coming out, but unfortunately Zero Shadow Blood decides to backdash instead of punishing.
Yeah, this is kind of going all over the place here. Oh, this is the corner when you least expect it.
Yeah, I don't think this is going to kill. Yeah, the Botengin will be baited, and Zero Shadow Blood will be taking game one.
Yeah, solid way to start it off, just killing off the Adachi early. Not having to deal with the chains plus 6P kind of neutral game that may be going on here. And that's good. You know, Zero Shadow Blood, one thing that I always note about their team. Oh, he's switching to it early.
Oh, yo, what up?
Man, this is the That Scrub David against the wall classic, the Kanji Yukiko. Usually we see it in reverse sweep scenarios when they're down two games, but no, this time the Hail Mary team is coming out just for being down one game against the Shadow Blood. So really going to be switching things up altogether. This is like, this is David saving grace. Every time he switches to it, it feels like such a Hail Mary pick, but like at least like 70% of the time it pays off. Like,
yeah, it's very very interesting to see the back against the wall team being used in this game two scenario. It'll be interesting to kind of see how this team fares compared to Zama Adachi. I will say, as someone who has played Yukiko into this team, it can be really awkward to kind of get those 6P calls, especially with that assist right there, that Susanoo 6P, but that's with David covering his space excellently, just able to snipe it out.
Whew. Kiko sniped in the back. Oh, the ballsy DP there from Datscope David working out. Did not hit confirm off the meaty button there.
Yeah, and we just saw right there how much that 6P will ruin your day.
Oh,
side. What freaking side.
No! Big yikes on the burst there. Not able to make contact with anything. Datscope David in a lot of trouble. Taking out of the corner. Trying to escape this pressure.
Yeah, goes for a throw bait. This JB plus 6P just putting this Kanji in lockdown. Oh, unfortunately drops the combo. Gotta be really careful. Kanji is not really able to punish that. Oh, that's from David. Really optimistic that that throw was actually gonna hit due to the JC to air stall, but unfortunately gets tagged on the landing. Still in the sandwich situation, but just DP straight out.
All right, this is a big call with the EX. No! Whoa! Never mind, it was a setup! It was a setup all along! That's actually big! Yeah, that's dead! Man, what looked like a drop combo was a reset all along, and that's where David's gonna be making a 1v1 situation. A lot of the resonance is gone, but this is an equalizer. It can go either way.
Yeah, goes in with the EX share. Zero Shadow Blood staying patient. Just not mashing on those plus frames. Oh. Okay.
Reverse hit 2B, not coming in too clutch for that script, David. Zero Shadow Blood will be able to find the 5B and bring it 2-0 here. So it ends. Leave now, while you still have your life. Oh man, that's good, David. Trying to dig deep with this Kanji Yukiko to make something happen. I mean, was almost able to get some signs of life with that solo Kanji comeback. Was able to take down at least a character, but Zero Shadow Blood proving a bit too tough for the task as they're switching back to Azama Adachi.
Yeah. Get ready. Definitely feel like Azama Adachi is a little bit more stable of a team comp. That script David did have a lot of good calls coming in with the Kanji, but unfortunately I don't think the Yukiko really got to do much in that scenario. She was at a pretty high fire level, but unfortunately since that script David poured so many resources into her and she just died, it wasn't really able to do much.
Let's raise a little hell, shall we?
Absolutely.
That's practically my job.
Oh yeah, Zero Shadow Blood on the verge of qualifying for that top 8 positioning. Would ironically be fighting Yo Fave Scrub, which is a W, even beyond WNF. They have also played a lot, so it would be funny if they met there. But Team Bathcup David has anything to say about it.
Yeah. Oh, that, what a sneaky side swap.
Oh, can we see the Oh man, just not close enough to kind of confirm off of that. It was a good idea from Zero Shadow Blood, just unfortunately not getting the full payoff for those reset calls.
Commit to the chain, the Susanoo is coming out, but hits the Yumi, an excellent conversion. Not sure if that's going to be a kill.
Not quite.
Oh, actually, grab the call out the parry.
Alright, that's Grub David is starting the game. Got a kill on the Yumi early. Some healthy characters here. Hit on the Susanoo incoming. Oh!
Yeah,
I think they thought the Susanoo was in the air. Going for an air unblockable. Measly 9.7k punish. Meterless, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, you know, Susanoo. Little stonks on the damage. Going to be calling out that burst with the 214B, and both characters suddenly not looking so hot. Gets hit by that counter hit throw, and it's all up to that scope, David, solo Uzama.
Very nice tick throw to bring to this 1v1 situation. Zero Shadow Blood trying to cast things in. maintaining this corner positioning so well, but the air-to-air here for Matchup David could be pretty big.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't know if that was a drop select or not, but either way, good defense on Zero Shadow Blood part. Both Resonance will be running out. He's moving so much. He's able to get the counter, or not the, the whiff punish conversion, and that's how David will be getting the first game on.
Very nice stuff here from that scrub. David kind of fired back. I mean, we saw David in this position before, right? In order to make this winner's bracket spot that they're currently in, they had to reverse sweep E2 Deku. So, I mean, back has been against the wall in familiar territory previously in the bracket. See if they're working on another reverse sweep against Zero Shadow Blood. That was definitely a solid kind of response, given the pacing of the match that we've had thus far. But still a tough task altogether. And Zero Shadow Blood actually switching for Yumi round start.
Yeah. If I had to theorize, maybe he just wants to get a P in just early on, because that 4P can cover a lot of Hazama's airspace that he wants to be in because of just how ginormous it is. He also has the advent of like EX Snowbirds, which also can cover a lot of the space that Hazama wants to be in. So maybe that's why.
Makes sense to me. See how well it works out. Definitely has a game to like kind of experiment here, so going with Yumi round start. Not a big deal, even if it doesn't work out, but here we go. Ooh, almost awful there for Zero Shadow Blood. Fortunately, Hazama was facing the wrong way.
Doesn't get hit. Good conversion, sets up a BZO. No push block.
DP coming in clutch. Oh boy, I think that was a missed air EX Snowbird.
Oh, excellent jump over the 2148. Just able to get reversed in.
Ooh, air unblockable check. Good throw tech. Yeah, trying to get on the offensive, get anything started. Another DP from that's from David.
Yeah, gets the crossover, but no full conversion. Snipes out the Yumi. Oh, that's a big chunk.
Quite the chunk is.
That has no info, unfortunately, isn't able to punish the burst. Excellent 2B call by Zero Shadow Blood. We'll be putting that script David Sazama in the corner. Not where you want to be, the same side cross up, whatever it's called. Coming in clutch, all up to solo Adachi right now.
Oh, finds the low. That's going to be wasting a lot of the resonance time here for that script David, depending on what Zero Shadow Blood wants to do with it. Yeah, it seems like they want to cash it in. Waste all that resonance time, have it be a non-issue.
DHC, that'll be all of it. Okay, didn't even really need it. What is she doing on that side? Gets hit overhead. If he builds an assist bar, I'm pretty sure that's a dead Adachi. Yeah.
Yes, that is definitely a game. Bring in the Susanoo. Spin, 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 and Zero Shadow Blood will be able to take it 3-1 over that scrub, David, and move into winner's side top 8. Once again, we'll be fighting Yo Fave Scrub, a solid set altogether there for Zero Shadow Blood to navigate through a PC tag and chill vet.
That's for sure. We'll be sent to losers, but that does not mean his tournament life is over. Look forward to potentially seeing him again in this top 8.
Absolutely, and it looks like we're going through top 8 right now. You know, bottom side between Chop Suey and Duck, you know, we're going to have that match on stream. There was just a bit of issues, but they looked like they were able to play it off stream. Chop was victorious. So first match for winner's side top 8 that we will have is indeed Forster Kirby versus Chop Suey.
Yes, yes.
So yes, Forster Kirby, definitely somebody that we've seen throughout PC tag and chill as well. Gonna be going up against Chop Suey's Chop's first PC tag and chill tournament. Pretty much some of Chop Suey's first PC tag matches all together. So, don't know if these two have played before in the past. I mean, I would have to imagine probably not. Forza Kirby not really within the PS4 landscape too much. I think they do have PS4 tag or have had access to it in the past, but I think there's gonna be the initial meeting of these two.
Yeah, I believe so too. And I gotta say, what a player to be having a first match with in a tournament. Forrester Kirby rocking with his classic team, the Tager Yukiko. Definitely a team comp that if you don't have a lot of experience against it, you are going to get hit in a lot of scenarios that you're very unfamiliar with, and it's very scary. Because, you know, initially you look at Terry Yukio and you're like, you know, these two characters suck. And then suddenly Podge hits you with, like, these crazy pressure combos, these, like, really hard to get out of grab scenarios. It can be very tough if you don't really have that MU experience. Reminds me
of the old days. Indeed, indeed. Well, this will be fun. I have no idea what to expect. I've seen these two players play so much over the past year, but seeing them play against each other is kind of weird. Here we go. Is what I would say.
Uh-oh. That ain't looking so hot, Chief. Oh. GBA tag being played out here.
They're still kind of moving along with it, though. It looks like the match is actually normal for them, possibly?
Maybe?
Spectator lag, maybe.
If
you look at the decision making and what's going on, and most of all, they haven't stopped, I think the match is fine. There's just some weird spectator lag going on.
Yeah. I definitely think there's at least some lag, but like, it looks okay.
I don't know. They're playing out.
Oh, Tager. No matter who you're playing against, if there's a Tager, they will have no brain cell. They just do wake up grab. Oh.
Wake up DP. Not bad. Not bad.
Yeah, Meteor is coming out. She ain't throwing no fans. Those won't be getting punished. Sandwich situation though. Oh, excellent use of the Yukiko DP just to get out of that situation. Oh, excellent use of the teleport to punish the 5BB. Interesting burst out from Podge's side. Sager is really low, has to be very careful. Oh, just gets hit by the wedge.
Oh, okay, yeah, it's gonna be bursting out of... Oh, but able to call raw attack with the meteors.
Yeah, it's gonna be a drop combo question mark? I think she lands in time, yeah.
Yeah, DP straight through it, don't worry about a thing. Good patience. Yeah, I gotta be able to bait out that burst. This will be big here for Chop Suey.
Yeah. Oh, unfortunately, a drop combo. Tager will be living. Goes for the wake up wedge. Not working out. And wake up pipe. I don't know what's going on anymore. I don't. Okay. That was something.
Yeah, the question is it spectator lag or what's going on here? Because, like, let's see. No, it's not spectator lag. The actual match was like that.
Oh, God. That... Yeah, that's unfortunate. Something with the rooms, I guess.
I suppose they're gonna be playing it off stream. Wonder what's going on, because Chop Suey has been playing through the bracket. I mean, they fought Almighty Waffle and Duck. I haven't been able to catch up with the Discord to see if those matches were better or what exactly is going on.
Yeah, it might just be something like the room is caught all that lag. I think it is primarily a hardware issue. That's the case, so the unfortunate things all around. Does Chop Suey have the improvement mod?
I have no idea. Chop Suey just got PC tag yesterday, so I have no idea.
Yeah, they might want to download the improvement mod if it's a FPS issue. Because it looks pain, but it's a very, like, consistent pain.
Indeed. Okay, so apparently improvement mod is in. But like, my question is, how have the off-stream matches been? If the off-stream matches have been of the same quality, then that's a little cap. But if it's just purely a problem with the on-stream matches, then that's weird.
Okay, they're saying for some reason the lobby is just better. So it's something weird with rooms.
Yeah, I don't know. Well, that's getting... We're figuring that out. But we're just going to the other side of Winter Side Top 8. We will be having Yo Fave Scrub and Zero Shadow Blood. Again, the nth time that these two have played against each other, this is a constant WNF Grand Finals that we've seen, but also some other tournaments that two have a lot of storied history. So we'll be interesting seeing them face off here. PC Tag and Chill 1 Year Anniversary Edition, fighting for that winner's final spot.
And Scrub actually committing to the Ragna Easyoid. Not opting to swap over to his main team, the Ragna Ruby. Just gonna be rolling with this team against Zero Shadow Blood.
Yeah, we will see how it works out here. Going into game one. I think is the lobby cursed?
Maybe the lobby is cursed.
I think the lobby is cursed. Look, this is par for the curse for PC Tag and Chill. Something always has to happen. This cursed port. Look, we've already remade the lobby. I think we all just restart the game. I'm down. Do we restart the game? I'm restarting my game. I'm out of here.
You know, just to be safe, just in case it's me, I'm also restarting this game.
Look, PC Tag and Chill, something cursed always has to happen. This port is whack. So restart the game just in case that is the issue.
Yeah. It's whack, but we love it. And despise it, mostly.
Indeed. It would make sense. Although it doesn't fully make sense, because I mean, we saw that happen with Chop and Duck. And then we've gotten to play a couple of other matches on stream, and they've been fine. But then we're seeing it between Scrub and Zero Shadow Blood. And there's like zero reason why they should have any lag at all. Like, they literally play each other all the time at WNF. So, yeah, hopefully with restarting everything, things are okay.
Get your PC tags in the chat.
Shout out to PC Tag.
You getting the room up or me getting it?
Oh, I have it up and everyone is here besides you.
Oh. I was like waiting for you to tell me the room was up, and I was like, man, this room it'd be taking a while.
I'm sorry, this is the second time I've just hosted the room without telling you. Okay, but we're all here. We're all seemingly good to go. I think this will be it. You know, you get the soft reset on the PC Tag, but there's going to be a soft reset on life, essentially, which means we're going to escape the cursed lobby zone. Everyone will be able to play on stream without any issue, but only for the next 45 minutes.
PC Tag runs on a timer.
All right, the match is a loading. And we'll be going straight into it again. Winners finals qualifying match between the two, Yo Fave Scrub and the Zero Shadow Blood. Here we go, game one.
All right. That looking normal.
Okay, yeah, the game looks abnormally fast for some reason.
is this what FPS looks like?
Yo, that's crazy. Yo, a full 60 of them things? Let's go.
That's crazy. Oh, interesting. No punish on the raw 5B. Oh, excellent block on the cross-up same side overhead.
Indeed. Oh, trying to bait a burst. Nothing. Scrub going to be DPing on the landing.
The 6B pressure, and now you're stuck here. Excellent blocks so far.
Ooh, what a DP!
Yeah, just ran into that one. We'll be swapping in to the Yumer. Is that gonna go through? Oh, doesn't even need to.
Yeah, that was a smart call from Scrub there to get that card. It says there's double Gauntlet Hades!
Hey, I'm telling you, man, that 6B has so much block stun, that's a viable mix-up with the team, I'll tell you what.
Oh my gosh, yeah, Zekrom Shadow Blood has just been in such a lot of trouble in this quarter. Finally finding a way out, Susanoo 6P helping out. Into the corner we go. Okay.
Nice pick on the throw. More DPs are coming out? It's a movement option.
Indeed, a sandwich creator as well. Solid defense from Zero Shadow Blood, not getting mixed up by the side swap, active swap. Yeah, just run out of that corner.
Sure that 6P confirms. Oh, I hope that chunk was just me.
I saw it as well. Oh, wait, buttons to get through everything.
I don't know if Philikid's stable. Oh, that big chunk is, big chunk is.
That was unfortunate. Rampage time has been activated as well. The 6P catches.
That fortunate drop is going to be coming back to bite Scrub, but all he has is a level 4 Resonance Ragna, aka two characters in one.
Okay, activates the level 4 Resonance.
Yeah, just using all this meter to push block out. I just don't want this scary Ragna in his face, but can't block an unblockable all up to solo Susanoo now.
Through it.
Yeah. Oh, that could have been really bad for Scrub there. Could probably going to be a confirm into Astral.
Oh boy, almost a big bait on the 2B there. Just wasn't quite close enough to come with a falling button. And yeah, we are still in rampage time. Both residents wasted on each side. 1v1. Flipsy.
Oh, but the Susanoo JP coming in more clutch. Does it tech the throw though? I don't think this is gonna be a kill, but this is a very huge scrub.
Yeah, still a solid life steal, right? You know, Ragna's gonna be getting so much life for this. Corner positioning as well, meets with the meaty. Zero Shot Blood just push blocking. Time is a big factor here. We're at 40 seconds actually.
Goofy Scrub playing very defensively. Yeah, can even get some health back with those B dead spike. Zona Ragna might be a viable strategy. It looks like that's Scrub, or not that's Yo Fave Scrub is just opting to play this very timeout game, but it could go wrong at any second. I believe either character is in the one touch zone. Does it counter hit confirm? But there it is, the 5A beating the Susanoo buttons, and Yo Fave Scrub able to take game one. That felt like two games in one, I tell you.
Yeah, that is definitely, as far as stream is concerned, the longest match that we've had on stream. Timeout was like legitimately a factor there. If they were really going to be playing the neutral in that slow of pace, then Yo Fave Scrub not committing to anything too wild. So really a insane match ball together, but Yo Fave Scrub going out on top. Yeah, it's super, super tense match all together. And Scrub not having to switch off of Easy Way quite yet. We're seeing what type of mix and pressure that Scrub gets access to with this Easy Way off of the 6P. Double Gauntlet Hades all around, you know, setting up sandwiches and the such.
It's a very, very terrifying thing team to have to deal with. He's been bullying me with it for the past week. Help me, God.
Indeed, indeed. Same. But yeah, let's see how this works out here. Because, like, oddly enough, with the Easy UI of Scrub, it's still, like, in development. You know, he doesn't have everything kind of going on. So we're seeing a more aggressive approach to Easy UI. There hasn't been really, like, a slowed down pace of, like, fireballs that we're kind of, like, used to seeing from Chop Suey. But, I mean, it works out. I mean, like, follow up with Ragnus, you're gonna get your mix started either way, so.
Just setting up his 6P, threatening the mix. Yeah, I had to stop that comp. Oh, gets hit low, but no full confirm, unfortunately. Just does run up, grab. Oh, what a dive. All according to K-Cock.
Indeed, yeah. It seemed like Zero Shadow Ball was too close to get that Axe Swap throw to actually work. So Scrub was trying to tech it, ended up getting punished for it accordingly.
Nice casual 9.3k on this.
A whiff DP here from Scrub, definitely not going to be paying off. Zero Shadow Blood will be able to kill.
Once again, in this solo Ragna position, but if there's one person in the world that can make it, it's definitely Yo Face Scrub, especially with Wake Up Card and Scissors able to tag that birthday, but gets hit by the Wake Up Parry.
Yes, a lot of health regained there for Scrub, but then a lot gone. Ooh, just whiffing on the jump in, and Zero Shadow Blood will be able to fire right back and get a game on the board for their own.
Leave now, while you still have your life. Face me again, and I will not be so generous.
Yeah, there is definitely some cursed PC tag actions that I've seen going on. PC tag is like the curse of PC tag is definitely erupting towards the latter half of this tournament. I'm definitely seeing the chunks go on as well.
Yeah, I don't know if it's a hardware problem or an internet problem. It's hard to tell on PC tag.
Indeed. But game three nonetheless, Zero Shadow Blood firing back, definitely a complete change of pace in terms of the length of the matchup, you know, basically less than half the time.
Yeah, that's for certain.
Oh boy.
Oh, unfortunately Yumi just falling out there. The six P's are still active, doesn't block the unblockable. Scrub not believing in it.
Scrub is seething at the moment. That is hilarious.
I have no words. This character is stupid. And I say this as one of her players.
Man, look at the payoff for it. Scrub in so much trouble. Yeah, you have not been able to skip the corner. Clutch active swap there from Zero Shadow Blood.
I honestly think he wanted to go for a God Press setup, but just because, you know, that's a EX action, just was able to auto correct into the sword super and still just getting that hit.
Definitely. Well, Zero Shadow Blood will be going up 2-1 altogether. Really, like, the difference maker was that jump C not making contact with the Ragna DP, getting that full unburstable conversion, quarter carry all day. And man, yeah, that's a big difference maker, the snowball effect. But Zero Shadow Blood is on the cusp of going to the winner's final side. This would be a. Yeah, I think they were in winner's final side yesterday as well. So this would be the second time doing so.
Said I needed your help.
Oh my gosh, a chunk on loading. PC tag, please.
Can't escape from crossing fate. Fight.
We stabilizing. It looks normal.
Wow, full retreat from Zero Shadow Blood straight into the corner. I will see if this pays off.
Yeah, can't block the unblockable Gauntlet Hades while letting Yumi take all this damage. More unblockables, just do them.
Yeah, this retreat from Zero Shadow Blood really allowed for Yoflip Shrub to kind of get things started. And yeah, Zero Shadow Blood is stuck in this corner. Oh my gosh, the top corner, a little bit of top turbulence with the DP. Oh wow.
Yeah, just waiting really patiently for that burst to come out. Sets up 6P, more pressure coming out. Zero Shadow Blood staying very patient, but yeah, good stroke keeping it in.
Oh, finds the low off of the jump C, and that's gonna be a dead system now.
Yeah, two full life characters, one low health Yumi. This is going to be a hard comeback to make. Oh, unfortunately whiffs the Hell's Fang. Zero Shadow Blood going in with the buttons, opting to end with the super early, just getting to get that damage. Anti-air 5.
Yes, I think mistimed on the jump aid there for Scrub, but yeah, definitely gonna be taking advantage of it. The Ragna's not quite dead though.
Yeah, just opts to push block and get the Ragna out.
Woo! Oh, 5B check, but yeah, possibly trying to make it burst safe. The confirm hit from Scrub. I don't routing.
That was very unfortunate, but the raw DP will be. Yo, face Scrub able to kick game 4.
It all works out at the end there. I thought that off the after swap he was maybe gonna go for counter scissors. I'm not sure what he actually ended up going for, but it still works out as we are tied up 2-2 now. Both of these players really trading off. Winners finals is the destination, going down to the wire between these two. Again, Scrub has not been switching to the Ragnar Ruby for, I guess, what has been the entire tournament at this point. I don't know what their off-screen matches are looking like, but the Ragnar Izioi is coming in clutch thus far. Zero Shadow Blood, definitely no slouch. Again, if they made Winners Finals here, this would be the second consecutive Winners Finals they've made over the past few days, as they were in Winners Finals yesterday for PS4 BB Tag and Chill.
Oh, excellent. Whip Punters on the 5A with the 4B, just gets up to the 6B pressure, gets the empty jump low.
Smart stuff. Oh boy.
The movement on.
Yeah, you see Scrub really calling in these 6Ps. Wow!
Whoa!
That was big!
Oh, that was also crazy. Gets the side swap, Grand Viper.
Ooh! Okay, yeah, this reversal super through that situation entirely. Both characters vulnerable. Sets up the sandwich.
Oh, and she blocking in time?
Oh boy, that will be a dead Yumi. Oh wow, able to get the pressure, but not too big of a confusion. Still getting opened up is Zero Shadow Blood.
I'm pretty sure this will be it in your face, Rub. Moving on to the grand final, or not, Flame Challenge, Winners Finals. gonna have to fight Chop Suey there. Zero Shadow Blood will be sent to the loser's side. Still has a chance at that grand finals placement, just gotta play a couple more games.
Indeed, indeed. Yeah, we have gone to Winners Finals territory. Hopefully, the issues have been resolved. Okay, it looks like we're calling YoFace Scrub and Chop Suey up just right now, just to see if things are stable and that it will be able to run. It's just a test. I mean, since this is just a test, we will definitely be putting up that match arena link if you haven't already. Use the code PCandChill29 for the free 50-cent donation. We are sitting at $112.10, so if you have not already donated, please do so. We're currently sitting at that number thanks to NeoCelest Gaming giving us a $100 pot bonus to kind of jumpstart this pot. Also, shout out to Yusuro for the direct donation. You can do direct donations if you'd like as well. You know, feel free to do so. Your generosity is appreciated. Check the marketplace. Kiten Books has some books for sale as well. But again, PC and Chill 29 for the free 50-cent donation to this pot as we're bringing back the BB Tag and Chill and PC Tag and Chill action after the March hiatus. Happy to have Guzman back. And yeah, the Guzman Show, of course, exclamation point Discord to get all of your Guzman gaming links. Of course, you could join the Discord if you'd like to take part of these BB Tag and Chill and PC Tag and Chill tournaments in the future. Follow Guzman on Twitter if you want to stay up to date with all the news that is BB Tag and Chill, PC Tag and Chill. And of course, subscribe on YouTube as well. To catch the VOD footage of all the tournament footage that does happen here on twitch.tv/GuzmanGaming1 alongside some original content from the one and only Guzman.
Okay. So currently we're just waiting for Chop Suey to get in the room so we can do this connection test.
Yeah, Chop hasn't responded, so Chop actually may be AFK at the moment. It wouldn't be far-fetched, because like Chop, given the area they are in the bracket, probably didn't expect to play so soon. Oh no, it's actually controller issues now. Oh man.
Oh, damn. There's unfortunately a lot of mishaps going on in this tournament, but I guess we're kind of used to it. It's PC Tag. Something always screws up.
Yeah, well, the bottom side of Winterside, or the bottom side of Winterside, yo, forehead. The bottom side of Top 8 has been filled out. We do know the participants that we have there, where it is Four Sword Kirby versus Zatchka of David and Zero Shot of Blood versus Duck. As Zatchka of David was able to get 3-1 win over Kamaku, and Duck was able to get 3-1 win over Jurassic Jack. Follow along with the bracket. But yeah, speaking of Scrub, I mean, like I said, I have all these stats, all these previous winners of BB Tag and Chill and PC Tag and Chills. In terms of one thing that Guzman does run a lot is like specialty tournaments. So we had like the Halloween tournament, the Fantasy Strike Rules tournament, the Tech Attack tournament, True Rules tournament, the Rampage Time tournament of like 90 Second Clock. There's been different winners for every single one, but Scrub is the only one to have won two. So, like, in terms of the specialty tournaments, Critical Resistance Furries 1-1, I got the Halloween one. Mega Ken, I think, won the Tech Attack tournament 2-1. But Yofei Scrub has won two specialty tournaments, the only person to ever win two of those. And it was, I should have wrote down what it was, but I think it was the Fantasy Strike tournament and another one that they were able to win. It might have been Halloween, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, Scrub is ready for the gimmick tournaments.
Yeah, I believe he won Fantasy Strike PS4.
Correct.
Yeah. Alright. This first game will be a connection test, so.
Get ready! Get ready!
Your phone's still in tournament.
Well, I'm definitely, I feel like Cheap has stolen the most phones, but like, who stole the second most phones?
Oh, it's probably Scrub.
Yeah, I definitely believe that.
Who said I needed your help?
My game.
Who said I needed your help? Pause.
They're not gonna say anything
actually, because oh.
It ain't looking so hot.
No, this doesn't look good. This doesn't look good at all.
In the name of justice.
You scared?
Wild.
In the name of justice.
You scared? Attack time.
In the name of justice.
In the name of justice. This is PC Tag and Chill, number 29. PC Tag, wouldn't have it any other way.
Yeah, I'll say, glad that our PC Tag anniversary was as jank as I thought it would be.
Yo, somebody has to alt F for it. PC Tag doesn't have a leave match option.
No, we're just gonna wait. Time high.
Okay. All right.
Good.
Yo, when's offline?
Yeah. The as someone who has never been to an offline event, please God, come back. I don't know what you are, who you are, but I need you in my life.
Yeah, things are being handled in the Discord now. I don't know what the final call is going to be, given the situation. I just know that Zero Shadow Blood and Duck are on stream.
Yeah, looking at the bracket, it looks like Chop Suey is DQing themselves, and their spot is actually being replaced by Podge.
I see.
But we won't be running out first. It looks like we are going to get our losers' matches getting going. Zero Shadow Blood versus Duckator up next.
Cool. Well, yeah, this will be for top four territory. If Zero Shadow Blood is able to get the dub here, would signify the run back between Zero Shadow Blood and That Scrub David, as That Scrub David is in that loser semis positioning now, based off of the DQ.
We'll be fighting the winner of this set.
Question is now, where's Duck?
Yeah, where is D-Doc?
I don't have any more shills. We've shilled everything.
Quick, bring us more facts.
More facts? Sure, let's see. Hold on. Well, look, so PC tag, that's Grub David, he's in top four. He is tied with someone else for the most amount of PC tag and chill wins, all right, at four. Who's the other player that also has four PC tag and chill wins?
Four PC tag and chill wins? Critical Existence Failure?
It is not. It's actually Flowerman. Flowerman also is tied for the most amount of PC tag and chill wins at four as well with that's Grub David.
Waffle telling me to spout out random Yukiko tech. Hold. 5B5C is a tech is a frame trap. Deadass. I kid you not.
You say 5B2C?
5B5C.
It's a frame trap. Frame trap?
Yeah. Straight up, it's a frame trap.
Broke.
What other random Yukiko tech can I spout? I don't know. That was the only one I have. That's the one I use at parties.
Well,
okay, he's back.
Spouting that was enough to kill time to make sure that we would get in matches. Zero Shadow Blood and Duck will be playing. This is for loser semis.
God. Who was it? Who was it? Zero Shadow Blood.
I'm about to throw my entire room out the window. Not my computer, not my desk, my entire room. I'm about to throw it out the entire window, bro.
Let us out of this hell! Let us out! Let us out!
This has to... It's time for a change. Look, what 1 year anniversary altogether? It may be time to move to the Parsec dimension. Guzman Gaming won. Look, all I'm saying, WNF has made the switch, but it is a larger scale of tournament. Things have to be figured out with Surface and everything, but it might be time to make the move.
You know, this port is pain.
Okay. The match do be starting, hopefully.
Please.
Zero Shadow Blood versus Duck. Top four qualifying match for loser semis. Game one. Here we go.
Okay, it looks normal.
It looks fine.
Double overhead schmicks.
Okay, reversal DP from Zero Shot of Blood. Definitely a little different than the Susanoo thus far.
Oh! Oh, that was an unfortunate drop combo. Have a lot of options from that point. Don't put this?
Indeed. Whip punch with 2B.
Yeah, just push blocking out. Excellent parry on the cross up same side of the overhead.
Yeah, with the active swap, I think Zero Shadow Blood actually pretty much trapped themselves on guaranteed getting hit. Slow plays. Oh, almost found a great opportunity for a 5B. Happy birthday. Just did not quite work out. A drop, but a reset.
Oh, active swapped a little bit too early. Oh, she's.
Woo! 5Bing.
Yeah, that was a good place to press that 5B there because if she does homing cancel, she can't block during it.
Oh, just run straight into the 4P.
Yeah, this will definitely be a kill. All up the solo heart.
Oh wow, yeah. Zero Shot has been pretty on point with the interceptions on heart homing dash, whether it be through the Yumi 5B or the Susanoo JB. What a clash.
Love is very stronger than God, apparently. Oh, it doesn't block the same side any cross up overhead.
And that will be a kill in game one going over to Zero Shadow Blood. Definitely was a strong start for Duck, kind of carrying Zero Shadow Blood to the corner. But yeah, they saw some crazy interactions. Heart, I really don't know what happened with Heart DP whiffing altogether. Crazy that she didn't come in contact with anyone in that corner interaction.
Yeah, that was wild. It was like, did Duck just DP? I wasn't sure. Just a lot of scrambles going on, a lot of unfortunate situations.
Yes, going into game two. One real notable thing about Duck's game is the potential to snowball of like getting those knockdown situations following up the Akatsuki 5P and making you want to push block. But definitely didn't get that full sense of that in the game one. So see if they're able to get a similar type of snowball game started here in game two.
We'll see. Definitely is a team that can both snowball via damage and Oki as well. It's got a very terrifying lockdown pressure.
Oof. Clipped off the 5P, just wasn't able to get anything big off Zero Shot, but definitely opting to meet Heart in the air.
Yeah, Susanoo JB is ginormous, so it is.
Ooh. Solid defense. Yeah, good defense with Zero Shot, but finding the perfect opportunity to counter poke. Ooh, yeah, that's good.
That might be dead, actually. Susanoo damage is pretty nice. Slamming Akatsuki into 4, 8.8k will seal it out. I didn't block that. I'm surprised Zero Shadow Blood did.
Ooh! Running straight into that Susanoo 4P, the no-fly zone being enabled here for Zero Shadow Blood. In pretty comfortable positioning, hasn't lost a lot of life on either side. Duck opting for the level 2 resonance right now.
After the resonance is gone, no really huge hit so far. That 4P setting up the sandwich, but no sandwich situation needed. I think this should kill.
Yeah, that 4P has been coming so clutch here for Zero Shadow Blood. And that will be game two, another ender, and just really looking comfy cozy in the matchup altogether. Duck, it has not really been able to get anything started.
Everything will be destroyed. No matter how the world may change, God's rule is absolute.
Yeah, it's been a solid approach from Zero Shadow Blood altogether. You know, really, I think stuffing the homing is definitely what's been coming into play. And we've already seen multiple kind of ways Zero Shot Blood's been able to do it, through the 4P, through Susan Jump B, and through Yumi 5B. So being able to play around that is already going to be a big part of kind of picking apart the team, and it's definitely showing. So game point here for Zero Shadow Blood, seeing if they will be able to get a run back against Bat Scrub David, moving on into the top four and top three territory. Game three for now, Doug found in trouble off the start. Take throw.
Oh, unfortunately a drop on Zero Shadow Blood's side. You do not want to let Heart go. Whew. That still was able to confirm? We're gonna be seeing a swap out, yeah.
Oh, it's a blow! Yeah, I don't think Duck was expecting that hit, so they just went for the Eitatsu. Oh man, another whiff on the parry, trying to nullify that sandwich mix as much as possible. Zero Shot of Blood did not pull the trigger on anything.
Oh. Unfortunately, I think the chunk kind of messed up that confirm there. Goes for another tick throw setup, and as long as there's no drop, that should be a kill, yeah.
Resonance active. Why is he over there?
I'm surprised that was blocked, but the Grand Viper coming to clutch wasn't able to get the access. The Heart will still be living, but this is not a good situation if that. What?
He got vacuumed into it. I did not know that super was going to hit, but somehow hitting behind and vacuuming in for the entirety of the animation.
Yeah. Nice counter hit. Confirm. Won't be confirming into a kill. Just push blocking the Heart out. Oh, and unfortunately, the 6P still active, catching Heart on the way down, plus the DP, and Zero Shadow Blood will be moving on into that top four position 3-0.
There it is, solid stuff there from Zero Shadow Blood. And I know, like I said, loser semis and top four positioning like 10 times, so I'm just not gonna say it again. They're moving on to the bracket.
Facts. They are factually moving on into the bracket.
That is something that's definitely happening. Oh man. PC Tag and Chill number 29.
Yeah. Next is Zero Shadow Blood versus That Scrub David. You run back from winner's side. Zero Shadow Blood did take it 3-1 over That Scrub David, but That Scrub David was showing a lot of signs of life during that set. Had a lot of excellent calls out, but unfortunately just wasn't able to like seal anything out into a real solid game win. Except the one game.
Yes, yes. So yeah, we'll see how this switches up. That Scrub David did try for the Kanji Yukiko. It did not quite work out going up against Zero Shadow Blood, but when they switched back to Hazama Adachi, those last two games, that's going to be, it seems like they were navigating a bit better. You know, they got a game on their end, and then the game afterwards, you know, they were able to get a little bit more of the game plan going. So if they're able to continue from where they left off, we might have a bit of a closer match. It's just going to be seeing if that's going to be able to truly continue from where we left off and grasp that momentum again. Yeah, I don't know what happened to Zero Shadow Blood. They went on to autopass. Okay, they're here. I thought they may have like walked away and like not expected that to play a match, but everything is good to go.
Top four. The winner of this match is guaranteed to get put into that pot. That sounded really weird, but you get what I mean.
It's not wrong.
Yeah. They do get put into a pot. It's just full of money.
Yeah, they'll be put into a pot and they'll be rewarded for cooking, you know? So.
Heck yeah.
So yeah, see how it all goes down. That's Grub David, PC Tag, and Chill. Veteran, multiple titles, tied with the most as we deduced earlier. Going up against Zero Shadow Blood. First PC Tag and Chill tournament, but not the first BB Tag tournament player as we've been seeing them time and time again. The secondary meetup between the two. Game one, round start, what do we got?
Start jump back. Zero Shadow Blood starting out with the pressure, but here comes Chain plus 6P. Oh, calling out on that wasn't actually a plus just with the 2A tap. Assuming it in a setup of 4 sandwich mid-screen, yeah, this can be very difficult to block.
Yeah, beautiful conversion here from Zero Shadow Blood. That's gonna be bursting, just kind of spare as much of Zuma life as possibly can.
Blood playing really patient, opt to swaps into the Hazama, a little bit risky considering there's no burst on deck.
Oh yeah, this Hazama's back in and they're in trouble, the God Press. Wow! Ooh. I find an opportunity to burst pretty much right at the last second there.
Yeah, oh, unfortunate assist call runs into the... as not looking good for that Scrub David.
Oh my! The corner, 4 bars on deck. That Scrub David is in a lot of trouble, and that's definitely gonna be game.
Yeah, it doesn't even need to spend the DHC, just a nice casual 10k.
Shadowblood continuing on with the momentum and definitely making it tough there for David. Like I said, we saw David able to show a bit of signs of life in the previous set towards the latter end, but the question was going to be if they were going to be able to pick up where they left off. But it seems like Zero Shadowblood is just dictating the pace immediately and not allowing David to get started. Yeah, see how that Scrub David will be able to play around this, right? Change plus 6p is usually the name of the game, but like the question is, like, in order to get that 6p out there, you're gonna have to be able to make sure that there's nothing on the ground that's gonna be contesting it. I mean, between Yugi Snowbird, Susanoo 6p, and just buttons in general from both these characters, it'd be easier said than done. So can't escape from crossing fate.
Fight. Oh, sets up the sandwich, just gets hit by the crossover, unfortunately drops the cup.
Oh, nice block on the active swap. Solid defense altogether until the very end.
Yeah, the first out of that situation. Yeah, I guess that sneaky throw setup.
Oh, just the 5B catching. That's good. David doing something, but it wasn't blocking.
Yeah, oh, an excellent crossover with the JB. This is very good. That might be dead straight up. Oh, unfortunately, doesn't cash out into super?
Yeah, I was actually surprised that Zero Shadow Blood went for the buttons in the first place. It didn't just do double super, because there was definitely some burst points there, and that's what David taking advantage of it.
Yeah, goes for the grab. Nice tech, though. I think that's a dead Susanoo, actually.
I think so. That's what David faced with a similar situation of being able to kill a character, and definitely going to be capitalizing on it as they bring down Zero Shadow Blood Susanoo.
I probably believe this is a better matchup for him.
Could be.
Oh. Nice crossover, but no, not able to confirm off it.
Yeah, one thing I definitely noticed about Zero Shadow Blood's approach to Adachi as a whole, because I've seen them fight a couple of other Adachis, they stay on the offensive. They do not want the match to be full screen, which rightfully so, you don't want it to be, but like they really make sure that the match is not going beyond mid screen. At any point whatsoever, that Scrub David finding the proper response and able to tie it up here 1-1. Interesting back and forth that we're seeing here between the two. Different pacing than before, because if I'm not mistaken, Zero Shadow Blood went up 1-0, forced the early Kanji Yukiko Gambit, and then went up 2-0, and then forcing that Scrub David to reverse sweep, but now we're just in a first two scenario for both players. But we did get to see some that Scrub David significant presence there. Like, they even just round started straight with the change plus 6p, you know, something that is such a like hard situation to deal with. The sandwich on block or on hit is just such a menace, but this time the 4p catching Zero Shadow Blood Susanoo.
Call able to just anti-air. Oh, goes for the greatest mix of all time, the 5c change plus 6p coming in, gets the command throw, tries to bait a burst early.
Yeah, not a lot of damage altogether from that interaction. And now, yeah, that Scrub David doesn't have a burst. Got hit by that jump C, and he's in big trouble.
Huge amount of damage. That was a very poor place to burst, but fortunately for that Scrub David, not going to get punished, but this DP will.
Yes, patience from Zero Shadow Blood going to be being rewarded with some unburstable damage, but a drop!
Yep. Gets the 2A grab. Unfortunately, drops the combo once again, or trying to bait a burst. Who knows? Swaps into the Hazama. Parry not in time, but excellent mash out.
Ooh, wow, yeah, nice conversion here altogether, too.
Yeah, I think that's going to be a kill.
Smart stuff, solo Adachi here for that Scrub David to try to make this comeback. Zero Shadow Blood has definitely been on top of him.
Situation goes for the empty jump low.
Yeah, that was a bit tough to see, honestly. Like, I didn't even realize that jump low is what was happening. He able to get some mileage out of this resonance.
Oh, goes for the heat riser. That is getting punished. If he builds the second bar, I think this might be a kill. No, opts to go for a four sandwich situation. Goes for the Atom Smasher, but it is baited, and Zero Shadow Blood able to take game two.
There it is. Yeah, Zero Shadow Blood, a game away from moving into top three territory here at PC Tag and Chill number 29, 1 year anniversary edition.
My man just set himself on auto pass.
They did. What happened?
I'm not sure.
You think the set is over? Wait, is the set over?
No, it's 1-2.
Yeah, it is definitely 2-1.
Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on. Zero Shadow Blood has not said anything.
I think they just straight up miscounted. I thought that set was over. No, it is. It is not 3-1. It is definitely 2-1.
It ain't Owari quite yet. That Scrub David still has a couple more games to play with.
Okay, we're back in.
We back in, we gaming now.
Yeah, a game away, but not quite there is Zero Shadow Blood in terms of getting into that top three positioning. Yeah, that Scrub David's back is against the wall. They aren't going for the Kanji Yukiko. I think that is the right call, because this Hazama Adachi is the only team that they've been able to get games with off of Zero Shadow Blood. They're still looking like a struggle, especially if that last match is anything to go off of. Let's see if they have anything left in the tank.
Scrub David's ability. We'll have to see it, but that is a good start. Excellent side bout. Just gets tapped low. Unfortunately, drops the combo, but just goes for a grab reset.
Oh my gosh, yeah, this has been so much chaos to happen just in 10 seconds. A lot of health gone from Zero Shadow Blood. Unrecoverable as well, but trying to get stuff started. Nice block here from that Scrub David. The mix is not quite over though. What a DP!
Yeah, just DP straight out. Fades out that reaction. Just jumps over the fan. That side, gotta be careful on the bluff. It's chunking a little bit. Oh, is that? Oh, he still gets a confirm off it!
Oh my gosh, able to recover in time off of the Yumi 6. It was nothing? That had to be a missed input.
Yeah, that had to be a missed input. There's no way he didn't want that. Is he losing Hazama for that? No, not like this. Not like this.
Yes, off that missed input, 12k for the punish, and it's solo Adachi to try to bring things back.
Yeah, gets hit by the cross up 5p.
Oh, big stabilization on the combo too. More than half of the resonance gone. They're cashing the super 2 to waste even more time.
Yeah, goes with the double overhead mix. Nice block, but puts himself in a sandwich scenario. Gets hit by the unblockable. Not going to be quite a kill yet, but this is going to be a tall mountain to climb.
Yes, this is rough if you're that scrub, David, especially in the way that it happened. Just one mistake, and this is where you're at. A bait on the super. And that will do it. Zero Shadow Blood able to take it 3-1 over that scrub David and move into that top three territory.
Conflict is unavoidable no matter what world I'm in. But as long as I live as a shinobi, I must.
A heartbreaker there for that scrub David, given the circumstances. I imagine that was supposed to be an AZO active swap. But Zero Shadow Blood moving and grooving throughout the losers. And yeah, although it wasn't a repeat scenario being in winners finals again, it is a repeat scenario of Zero Shadow Blood being in top three guaranteed for both BB Tag and Chill yesterday and PC Tag and Chill today for these 1 year anniversary brackets. But yeah, we are actually jumping to winners finals, and this bracket is completely transformed to where this just looks like a WNF Parsec bracket now.
Yeah, we got the West Coast gang all in top three right here. Fortunately, due to some hardware issues, Chop Suey did DQ themselves. So instead of Chop Suey versus Yo Face Sword, we'll have Yo Face Sword versus Podge.
Yes, Yo Face Scrub versus Four Sword Kirby. Scrub has not switched off the Izzy way to the Ruby quite yet. It has been locked into the Ragna Izzy way for the entirety of the bracket, at least from the matches that we've been able to see. And yeah, we don't really have to call into question how much experience they have against Podge's team, because they've definitely played quite a bit. Four Star Kirby making the call out, saying, "Come at me, yo, Fullman Scrub."
No, what are you calling out? Scrub did say in the chat, Fullman is in fact his father, so... That makes sense. I guess Fullman's just the middle name. Yo, Fullman's.
We shall see.
Yeah. These two definitely have a lot of MU experience against each other, but I'm not sure if Podge has ever gotten the chance to fight Scrub's Ragna Izzyoi yet.
Ironically enough, they've been trying to get games for like the past couple of days, but they've just been missing each other. I don't know if they actually got a chance to play, but yeah, this may be the initial interaction.
Yeah, and what a round start. The sledge into the 2C. Ooh, an unfortunate drop on the combo does set up this full screen CC pressure, but Tager does get slapped around. Oh, that's a punish on the landing.
Yeah, air stalling with jump C, punishable on the way down, and boy, there was no burst available for a lot of that combo. What a way to go, but...
Ooh, is that... Okay, I was like, please, punish... Oh, Jesus Christ, that did a lot of damage.
Oh, boy.
Yukiko isn't looking so hot right now. That is a bad act, but is not going down. Got those gamer roots on deck, though.
Oh, trying to bait out a DP, of course, with Kirby not biting.
Oh, nice block on teleport, but this is still a sandwich scenario. Nice DP out.
Scrub needs to be careful. Yeah, recognize that Ragnar was low. That was so misinputting the spark bolt actually ended up working out, because when they actually got the spark bolt, it ended up hitting Izzyoi.
Frame trap.
Gets health back on the Yukiko. Smart stuff here for Force Kirby. Oh, no.
Yeah, that 5A does have armor, sets up the sandwich, but not in a full confirm. Going to get a punish on the landing.
Yeah, this is decent for Scrub here. Some momentum with this solo Ragna. Oh, but yes, very nice call there in neutral. Able to get a confirm and force Sir Kirby. Able to get a game in this winner's finals. Starting off strong here is Four Sword Kirby. The question is, how committed is Yo Fave Scrub gonna be with the Ragna Izzyoi? I mean, they were in a similar scenario against Zero Shadow Blood, and they didn't switch off to the Ruby, so I'm guessing they're just gonna be committed to this for the entirety of the bracket.
Yeah, I would assume so, especially since it's still being locked in here.
Yeah, truly one thing that I am noticing is that given the, you know, fans and everything that Yukiko was able to put on the screen, there are a couple of assist calls that I'm seeing stuffed from Yofei Scrub. And I mean, one constant thing that we have been seeing is definitely that Ezio 6P coming into play, right? Just enabling Scrub in such unimaginable ways that I think Scrub has fallen in love with in terms of this team or what Ezio 6P can bring to the table.
Yeah. He has stated himself he is an Ezio 6P main now. Excellent call out on the air dash, just unfortunately not able to combo and just gets prepared for his trouble.
Yes, very nice confirm here from Scrub. In the corner, yeah, that Ezio 6P coming in so clutch. I don't even know if that was a punish. I think Kirby might have been stuffed on a 2B.
I'm not. What?
Craziness. A lot to push blocking going on. Nobody wants to take pressure.
Yeah. Oh, gets the counter confirm. Unfortunately, Tager doesn't really have a good way to deal with that 6P.
Yeah, 6P being such a lifesaver in that circumstance. It's something that was approaching you have to deal with, even on hit. And it's like, well, I guess I'm blocking now. Such a slow pace of game that we're seeing here all together between these two.
Nice counter hit confirm. Pops the burst out to save Yukiko, but no full confirm off it.
Wasn't quite ready for it. Oh, sneaky stuff off the teleport and the 5P-esque of Ruby there with that mix-up.
Once again, try to bait the burst with the dash with that. Hodge not biting. Oh, almost falls for the wedge, and the Tager will be going down. Pops the resident immediately, and that was such a sneaky cross-up.
Very nice find there from Scrub as they're able to fire back here. And kind of really just max pace there of Podge, you know, Forcer Kirby. Again, those Yukiko fans were playing such a big deal in the game one, but now just kind of matching that pace, you know, being able to play the neutral game and still find those easy 6Ps, just threading the needle there. So good on there for Scrub to find an adaptation and get a game on the board for themselves. But yeah, there were a few drops there from Force Sword Kirby in that previous game. I mean, so part of the big reason why Scrub was able to get the corner positioning was the whiff punish off of the drop there from Podge with the throw. So some cleaner gameplay. Game three already in a sandwich is Force Sword Kirby, but the DP out, that Tager DP is so nice to get out of sandwich situations if you're right. But a mistake shortly thereafter. A happy birthday. This is big here for Scrub.
Pressure, more DP is just coming out, tries to bait something there. In the corner, I think he tried to go for the unblockable, just mistimed it.
Could be. Nice. He's a movement option, but nullified.
Oh, more DPs coming out. All these DPs are really working out for Podge.
Definitely, he's been really on point with them. Ooh.
Yo, please, why are you throwing the fan that way?
Reversal throw here from Podge working out. Possibly trying to throw tech, but ward it with damage instead.
Oh, she jumps in and will be getting punished. Unfortunately, no confirm to a kill, just DP's out of the situation, though.
Yeah, I think Podge was a bit scared of two things, the DHC and the burst. Trying to cover all options on the fly and almost had a good response for it.
Oh, tries to go for a reset. Yo, face drop, not falling for it, but just armor straight through it. But no assist punish on the burst. Ezio will be living. Nice DP out once again, but just gets hit by a taste of his own medicine.
Ooh. This is getting rough here. Oh! Actually bait out one of those signature Podge DPs we've been seeing all set long, and Tager dies for it. Scrub's characters, yeah, they're so on the brink of death as Ezio goes down immediately.
Yeah, oh, just immediately wake up, DP. What?
Oh, my, the great equalizer, the 5C. Podge getting that Ragnar off the low. Miragi makes contact, and Forcer Kirby is going up 2-1 now.
It's a low. unfortunately maybe catching a jump frame in that situation, but yeah, getting Lodge taking King 2.
That 5C was so beneficial in so many ways, right? To be able to hit with that and then move Scrub to full screen positioning, not have Ragna up in your face, was definitely great. But yeah, Scrub, again, in this 2-1 position, they are not swapping. They're like, nope, I need that 6P. I've seen the light. I gotta make Fullman proud. I would just be a fraud if I just drew Ruby now.
Yes, he will commit. He will make his father proud. He'd be committing to this team, and he's gonna have to win 2 more games with it too as well to make it to that grand finals position.
Yes, we'll see if Scrub is able to prevent the fate of falling to the loser side. That would be a run back between YoFace Scrub and Zero Shadow Blood, who has been making nice work with the loser's bracket to get up to this point so far. But here we go.
Oh, just gets hit by the raw 5P. Excellent, just able to convert off this pull. The Ezio Burst just dodged the 6P?
Altogether, yeah, and I mean, Scrub actually made very good positioning of like that screen stretch from the cross combo to get two Ezio mix-ups there with the dash. That was pretty smart.
So that one catches to get a little bit extra damage. That actually might be a dead Tager with the cross raid. Oh, just barely not!
Oh, what a snipe out there with the DP. Didn't get the full ender, but still good stuff there from Scrub. That Tager is so low. Kirby has to be a little bit careful about calling the assist, but that's quite all right.
What? What? Dude, I'm telling you, man. Yukiko is OP. Top zero character. You see crap like that? Name another character that does that.
I did not know that Yukiko was actually Jubei the entire time. That was insane.
Look at this.
The big punish. How is Force Sword Kirby gonna end this? The whiff on the two.
Oh no!
Unfortunate!
Yeah, not gonna be a huge amount of damage. Ezio is not that great, but nice block and just burst out of this situation. Gotta be careful with this. Ezio, but what a clash!
You don't have bomb!
What? Lots of spaghetti. Lots of spaghetti going down. Gauntlet! Harvest of Gauntlet Hades! Blow! Check!
Gosh.
Wait, no, she's dead!
Dead! Fully chaotic scenarios there, but it was the last bit of chaos that ended up being the greatest and the most amount of detriment to Force Sword Kirby, as they were now tied up here 2-2. Oh my gosh.
Man. I don't know what to say about that round. That was just Scramble City.
Yeah, there was just scrambles back to back all together. Just, oh man. We're at the end with the happy birthday. Carded Scissors, Ragna bringing it all together. Just,
whew. Man, I mean, Yukiko's been getting hit so much of it, like, I can't close my. Crazy.
Oh boy. Yeah, won the round start, easy O6P to back it up, high-low. What?!
I am so impressed that he stabilized all that, but this gets hit by the 5P, stabilizing with the Sparkle and reports the charge to come up and face the DP, but that's the so many spaghetti moments.
Forcer Kirby, do a combo. Oh my gosh, he may not even get a chance to.
Oh no, I think the burst is gonna come in time, yeah. Saving the Tager, but Yukiko will be getting hit for a good amount of damage off this. Gets set into the corner, trying to bait a DP there with the shimmies.
Yukiko fans trying to slow things down. Only two Agi stack. Yeah, Force Sword Kirby, just keep Ragna away from me. Ragna's creating all the chaos. If we can just slow this game down, if we can talk this out, like, oh no!
Oh, yeah, it's gonna be
for it. Oh my! Creates air unblockables too?
Whoa! That almost worked.
Gaming.
And now I'm all up solo. You know what? I take back everything I see. You can go sucks.
Unfortunate that I instant air blood side switch inside, not overlapping with any parts of Yukiko's hitbox during her DP, and YoFace Scrub will be able to take it 3-2 and move into grand finals.
Yeah, and what an insane set, to say the least.
There it is, Forrester Kirby dropping to the loser's side. There was a lot of points of possibly some symptoms of chaos that Forrester Kirby could have made there. Just like the scramble scenarios, not being ready for some confirms, really was a detriment that Forrester Kirby, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah. Especially with how unstable Yukiko teams can be, considering she's like 16k health and, you know, loses health on every fire boost. You don't want to be caught in a situation where A, she's getting hit, and B, you drop your combos, and then she gets hit.
100%. Well, yeah, we'll have to see if Forsword Kirby is able to get it together. They are basically in the gauntlet now. They are in the loser's bracket side, having to go up against Zero Shadow Blood. Loser's finals here.
Yeah. Oh. It just went over the Phoenix, I guess.
I guess so. Yeah, push block to Susanoo, but yeah, you are not out of pressure against this team. This Yumi 5P keeping you locked down.
I don't think he wanted that Snowbird. Oh, try to go for like a jump read. Oh, sneaky cross up. Dagger, we're putting it in the corner.
Ooh.
Yeah, no solid hits so far. Just gets the DP. Excellent place to do it with that jump. Sets up a sandwich situation, but Yumi is not blocking anything. Excellent coverage with the Spark Bolt, just able to get the punish.
Yeah, that was super smart. Forrester Kirby noticing that Zero Shadow Blood really wanted to, you know, apply pressure on the assist to Kiko, and just said, okay, if you're gonna do that, just make sure you're expecting the Spark Bolt too.
Up some full screen CC pressure. Gotta be careful of the sword super. Looks like this Podge is trying to bait it out here. Oh my, that could have been disastrous.
That was such an interesting usage of cross combo, just like constantly up backing with Yukiko and not doing anything with Tager. It's just a complete stalemate.
Yeah, oh, puts himself in a sandwich scenario. This is not where you want to be. Good place to burst out though.
Yeah, not bad, especially with the life lead that Forrester. Oh boy, I think he may have thought he had a happy birthday. Oh my god, the spaghetti is. Forrester Kirby, do a combo! Oh my god!
No, Podge will be going down off that unfortunate interaction. Level 5, Yukiko though. Yo, 5C.
5C, the great equalizer, the great stabilizer.
Yeah, gotta be very careful. Base the DP, this should be a kill on the Susanoo.
The battle of the fans. Yumi and Yuki.
No!
He didn't have it. I think he went for it. He's Meragi.
I'm
just
leaving the room. I'm leaving the room. Oh, God.
Right.
So whoever that character is getting after him. I don't see it.
Man. What a way to go, right? Like, to not only get hit by the Yumi Astral, but the reason why you got hit is because you went for EX Meragi and you didn't have bars. Like,
yeah, that was looking like a kind of even situation on Plodge's side, and then 5C happened.
Unfortunate stuff.
Not a very pleasant way to go out.
Man, every Tager in the world right now is in chat and upset.
Get ready. It was looking good for him for a little bit there. Got a couple DP baits on the solo Yukiko. Unfortunately, we really didn't get to see that solo Yukiko play because the meter kind of be important.
Well, here we go. Zero Shadow Blood firing first in this loser's final set, going to game two.
Oh, that was an excellent go to the top of Collider just to call out that. Unfortunately, no full conversion, gets crossed up by the 6P. Goes for the reset, but not falling for it this time.
Oh man, yeah, using Tager as a meat shield there.
Shadow Blood playing it very patiently. Oh yeah, just waiting for a situation like that to happen, and goes for another reset and another DP to call it out.
Man, yeah, he keeps that active swap call, but you gotta be careful, those hits are gonna add up over time.
Yeah. It's up this corner. Pressure gets tapped low. Yeah, does not confirm into a super.
Oh my god.
Oh.
Tigger has been. I don't know what. Like, Tigger's purpose in this match is so hilarious. Like, he's actually just been getting so much usage out of just letting Tigger get hit, and that seems to be the game plan. It's working, but it's just really interesting gameplay.
Yeah. Autocorrect fans. I don't know if that could have been a kill to be just extended it, but DP will be coming out.
Yeah, since he wasn't sure, it was smart not to do it, because Tigger was kind of low in that instance, so bringing him in would have been a little sus.
A little bit of risky DP. Doesn't try to fish for the kill another time, but sets up the full screen pressure once again.
This is the game plan! This is literally like the... He just wants the Tigger in front of Zero Shadow Blood and let Tigger take... Like, that... That interaction right there was literally a complete showcase of Forcer Kirby's game plan in this matchup. He's just throwing Tigger in or getting Tigger out, having him be vulnerable, and then seeing if he can, like, love tap Zero Shadow Blood. And, like, it was adding up over time. It's just Tigger never died. Like, this is something.
You know, I fought against Podra many a times, and never has he done CC full screen into. Do nothing.
It's so weird. Like, I don't really... But it's working. That's the thing. It's so weird, but it works. I don't have an explanation for it.
Yeah.
Having someone watch my back isn't half bad, okay?
Oh, man. Does that put us at 1-1?
2-1.
2-1? Oh, my god.
Wait. Is it 2-1? That... No, it's 1-1, according to the scoreboard. That felt like two games, man, for how crazy that was.
Oh boy, yeah, this time taking the mix. No DP from Podge, but bringing Yukiko in instantaneously.
Yeah. Tries to call out something? Yeah, Yukiko can't really get... Did my mans really just do fire boost there?
He did.
Podge, please, you're hurting. Okay, sets up the force sandwich. I think she's gonna... No, she doesn't take out at 5C coming after Zero Shadow Blood. With 4A into the command grab. Oh, yeah, he messed up the unblockable that time.
That is correct. Another force sandwich, force with Kirby.
Oh, goes for the wake up mash. Zero Shadow Blood DPing out this time. Yeah, you're looking kind of low.
All right, well, yeah, Tigger is kind of low, right? So is Forcer Kirby going to stick to that game plan of, like, calling Tigger out and, like, controlling Yukiko? But, yeah, that is a rough spot to get counter-poked out of.
Yeah. Yeah, that's going to be a kill on Tigger, I'm pretty sure. Doing a lot of damage.
Yeah, given if it was off of double 5P, you know, the scaling is there, so I had to spend 4 bars in order to get the job done. But the job is done. Is solo Yukiko coming in? 5C? No. 5C? No.
Not yet.
5C? Oh, crap.
Okay. No, he didn't check out!
Oh, man. Well, that was definitely a fatal decision there for Force Word Kirby to not tech, as Zero Shadow Blood is now up 2-1. A game away from moving into grand finals.
Yeah.
Man, the spaghetti for Force of Kirby is adding up. It's looking like a Olive Garden all-you-can-eat pasta bread bowl in terms of the amount of spaghetti that's really here. But I mean, the thing is, you can't cash in spaghetti for BB tag wins. That's not a true conversion. So I mean, Pod's gonna need to find something if they want to stay in this bracket.
Yeah, getting hit by that throw is certainly not a good start.
Into the corner we go. Oh, that was almost sick. But it works out.
Oh, tries to beta burst in that situation there. Oh, base the DP too. This is gonna be a ton of damage on Yukiko. I don't want to see it. But...
yeah, it's definitely gonna hurt. It could have been worse, but opting to end things early, baiting out another DP, force her Kirby. Now you close your eyes.
Yeah, it's just dead. Who's dead? I don't know. I don't see. Solo Tager? Like, what happened?
Solo Tager, the person, the robot he's been using as a meat shield all along. All the pressure is on them. Level 1 resonance. I mean, the grappler mindset is working out so far so good.
What side?
Cross up JB, you know what it is. He's making good pacing. The grappler mindset is
the 5C!
He didn't even do a combo!
He just needs combos.
It works, I guess.
Combos. We got 5C, brothers.
Oh, boy. He has
the spark bolt will get him. This drop. You go into the core. Is he dead? Is the grappler bright cell over? No, he drops the combo! Spark bolt!
What? What is happening?
What is it?
Oh my gosh.
Goes to the wake up bash! Punch! Do a combo! Punch does a combo! Punch does a
Yo, Punch did it! He did a combo!
Punch did a combo!
Holy crap. Somebody clip it.
That was only 2-2. That was only 2-2, folks. We still got another game.
This is some of the most PC tag and chill energy I've ever seen. Oh my god. I'm tearing up.
I need water. I'm shaking.
All right, with the Solo Tager comeback against Zeo Shadowblood's nearly full health team, it is set up this game 5 scenario between Forcer Kirby and Zeo Shadowblood. This can go either way, I guess.
I don't know anymore. It gets hit. The pressure. Okay, everything's looking normal. Standard pressure using that beat shield of the Tager. Just gonna play some solid fan neutral.
Oh boy.
Nice defense so far, but gets smacked by the 6P. Doesn't block the JC though.
Oh wow, I don't know if there was a burst available. Doing it now is definitely not the right time for Third Kirby. We're really getting some more damage on the board here for Zero Shadow Blood. Corner positioning, even building the assist back, this is a tough scenario to be in.
Yeah, does it go for the Grand Viper? Is that gonna overthrow? What? This is a 4-sword energy. Kirby energy right here goes. He's not dead. This is a. Oh god! Wakes up with a spark bolt. Calls out the Axis Swap. Gonna be put in the corner. Gonna get some healing. Gonna swap into the Yukiko. Goes for the 4 AOP, but gets hit.
Ender!
No, the Meraki dying. The Meraki dying. Gonna be coming in clutch. Putting in all that damage on the Susanoo. Gotta be careful with him now, but Zero Shadowblood has so much meter on deck that if he gets one hit, it's definitely gonna be a kill.
Bro, this match is so
funny. He's setting it up. Excellent! The Yukiko is still there. There's no meter to really do anything. That's hit. The DP's out!
That was the perfect timing for that DP punch!
Oh, it's not done! Do a combo! Flash, do a combo! Flash, do a combo! No! That's what into a sandwich. Gotta be careful! Oh, Augie died! Not gonna be able to punish it! But gets the assist on Rokis, so I don't think that's gonna kill his...
Okay. Stabilization.
Oh, no,
a 20k character. I think this might be the before I hear it though. Zero Shadowblood. Able to take it 3-2 over 4 Surge Kirby. and we'll be moving on in the grand finals. That how it was definitely close. It could have went either way, but these drops really just started to add up. There was such a big hit with the proper confirm could have possibly meant a dead character, but it will be Zero Shadow Blood that's able to make sense of the chaos at the end of the day to create the grand finals that we see here. The run back from winter semis, Yo Faith Scrub versus Zero Shadow Blood, the WNF Classic. Things are winding down here at PC Tag and Chill number 29. If you haven't already, don't forget the code TC and Chill 29 for the free 50 cent donation to the pot. We're currently at, I got signed up for inactivity. What is it? $112.60. Thank you for your donations thus far. I'm gonna get some water. Hold on. It's right here. But I can't speak. Oh man. What a loser's final set. Here we go. Grand final stage is set. Yo Faith Scrub versus Zero Shadow Blood. Yo Faith Scrub winner side still locking in the Ragna Izayoid. No intention of switching over to Ragna Ruby for the foreseeable future. It's going to be up to Zero Shadow Blood to force it out of him, if that's even something that he has in his mind at all, because it seems like he's been committed all tournament long with the team, and rightfully so. It's been working out. You know, solid Izayoid 6Ps and Ragna gameplay, but not for nothing. We have been seeing Izayoid do some more work in some of the latter halves of these sets. You know, Izayoid has definitely been pulling her weight, but Zero Shadow Blood also has been doing some nice work throughout this tournament. Again, something worth noting, Zero Shadow Blood was in top 3 yesterday and now is guaranteed top 2 today if they're in the lobby. I'm not quite sure what happened there. But
he's restarting his PC tag.
Oh, okay, no worries. I missed it. Oh yeah, the good old player card stuff not showing up in the loading screen. That's a good idea to restart there. Oh boy. Man. Oh man. The cursed energies just like they have not gone on break here at PC Tag and Chill. They're just back in full fashion.
I'm not emotionally ready to say anything about that game until I really think it out for the night.
It's a lot to process.
Either way, grand final set, Yo Faith Scrub, Zero Shadow Blood. We ain't in WNF, but it certainly feels like it. Grand finals, the classic. Here they are. Yeah, drink water.
Yes, definitely drink some water. I know I felt very parched after that last match, but I can't take it anymore. I simply can't take it anymore. What's happening? Why?
I'm gonna need some therapy after this.
Same.
I don't know what cursed stuff you've seen in your lifetime, but this right here, for me, it takes the cake for how cursed it is.
It's been one for the books, to say the least. What happened? How is everyone doing? I hope you guys have been enjoying the PC Tag action today. Hey, you know, if you really enjoyed it and you want it cemented forever, you never want to forget this moment. You know, Guzman will eventually have you covered over on the YouTube, so be sure to subscribe to him on YouTube to catch VOD footage of all BB Tag and Chill, PC Tag and Chill, and other tournaments and some original content as well. Link is in the chat. Follow him on Twitter. Stay up to date for future BB Tag and Chill and PC Tag and Chill tournaments, and join the Discord if you want to possibly join one in the future. because Guzman is back in action for the BB Tag and Chill and PC Tag and Chill tournaments as a whole. What is happening?
I don't know.
My brain cells. I've lost too many brain cells to like, because for every gap, I've donated a part of my brain cells to fill in that gap. But the thing is, the more that I donate part of my brain cells to fill in the gap, I lose the ability to do so more and more with each and every time. So it's just like, it's tough.
All right, game one, grand final set. It's gonna be good, guys. Trust me. No, I'm not gonna say anything. I won't say a single thing.
Bro, I have a headache.
Yo, same.
We're going into it. Yo, face scrub. This is Shadow Blood. Ready your weapon. PC Tag and Chill. It's not BB Tag and Chill. That was yesterday. Grand Finals, number 29. Here we go.
Zero Shadow Blood is baiting the first, but go. Never mind. It was a reset.
Yeah, if anything, that actually ended up being better.
Yeah, I got the best start. Oh, just really patient. Zero Shadow Blood side, and just like that, the Izioi is going straight down.
Yeah, the thing about this for Scrub, I mean, not much changes about the gameplay. It's still Ragnarfront loaded. There's just no more Izioi 6P, right?
Oh, it doesn't block the overhead in the 4A, not catchy. Yumi, and that should be a perfect round one.
Man, what a way to start us off here. Starting off with the perfect here from Zero Shadow Blood.
Yeah, just after, especially that emotional Lunar Reserve Finals run, just able to keep it solid, make the right calls, and get that game one on the board.
Yeah, the pressure here for Scrub here, I mean, the perfect on the board is always going to be some psychological damage in some type of way. But I think Scrub may even be unfazed by the perfect. What really has to be phasing Scrub here is getting perfected while Father is watching. Fullman is in the chat.
Oh, no.
I mean, like, I think that would be the real psychological damage there if you're Scrub. Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
Before the match started, say, son, we need to talk. That's shit right there, dude.
Oh, God. He's losing his flight privileges.
Oh boy. You better take out the trash. I don't know what you're doing over there. You've been letting it pile up for days.
Everything. Okay, people are just getting hit. Resets are happening.
People are getting hit. That is an accurate observation. For Sandwich.
Yeah, blocks the right side this time. Nice tech on the throw.
Right, Scrub. Oh yeah!
Oh, that was so cheap.
That was very smart. Rather than finishing this combo that was already scaling so bad, just going for a mid combo reset. Definitely got to get a lot of damage off of it. Ooh,
full screen. The greatest mix up of all the 5C uses that time to swap into the Yumi.
Wow, stuffing the 5B, but did not get a conversion.
Oh, the 4B hitting. I don't know if these are drops or burst baits or not, but either way, the Ragna will be going down.
Based off the double 5B, I think that was a missed 5BB there from Scrub.
Yeah, I think that's also what happened in that scenario. Yeah, the big comeback character is down, but both those characters are fairly low, but no full confirm on the 5B. Another unfortunate drop.
Oh my gosh.
The spaghetti, it never stops. Okay.
What is happening?
Why did she not cross? What, that didn't hit? She's dead?
Well, 1v1 situation is Yoi versus Yumi. One way or another.
Okay.
Just simply fuck there.
Just the Yumi butter.
Yeah, we here.
The DMCA is you.
Okay. So the thing about getting hit by an Astro for Yo Face Scrub, it's not getting hit by the Astro that's the problem. Because, you know, when you get hit by an Astro, it's going to be psychological damage either way. The thing getting hit by the Astro is getting hit by the Astro while Father is watching.
And he just told you to take out the trash. He's like, son, I told you to take out the trash 20 minutes ago, and here I see you getting slashed by this crazy ice lady. What are you doing with your life? Get a job!
Oh my gosh, asking for the router for Netflix, saying you don't deserve it to use it for your silly little PC tag tournaments anymore, alright? I'm gonna be catching up on some shows.
I'm gonna catch up on that Netflix anime.
Oh man.
I don't know how much more I can take.
I don't know. I am like, I have been drained of a lot of energy. I'm giving it all I got.
The crazy part is that we still have another potential set after this.
It's true. Zero Shadow Blood is on reset point here, being up 2-0 against YoFabe Scrub. We shall see. Not switching over to Ragna Ruby. Staying on Ragna EZOi for the remainder of the set. It would be pressure on them to reset the bracket. Or not reset the bracket. Reverse 3-0. My brain cells are lost, bro.
I was almost agreeing with you that entire time until you said my brain cells aren't working. I realized mine aren't working either. 5C. Brain C, 5C, I understand that. It's the best mix.
5D combo here for Zero Shadow Blood. Oh, okay. Yeah, up backing, not having to deal with that 2-360. Is that gonna bleach? It clapped!
Oh, my ears.
It actually clapped!
We press the buttons too afterwards. Who cares about your plus frames? They don't exist! My plus frames.
Oh, solid throw tech.
Yeah.
Oh,
press.
Bursting right at the end there, bringing Izzyway back in. She runs straight into a 5A. This is rough for YoFabe Scrub.
Wow, just wake up, mash, but I don't think Zero Shadow Blood realized that he was on that side.
Yeah, I guess so. Could have been an air raid. I'm guessing that 5C was a mixed. What is? Please.
Buttons are being pressed. Bro, I have to swap. Boosh movement? The conversion, 5C again, the master.
Man.
Go straight back in. All right,
sandwich. In. Oh, yup.
Yeah. Doesn't block the cross up, no burst available. Why is she on that side? Okay, we're resetting the bracket. Their bracket is being reset.
Dude, you're right. I'm glad you said that, because I was going to say the Zero Shadow Blood 1, but no, that's actually a bracket reset. I forgot. Oh, man. I'm telling you, dude, I'm out of brain cells. Like, I'm actually legitimately out of brain cells.
My question is, will YoFabe Scrub change over to the Ragna Rube? Will he stick with the Ragna EZOi? His father is a little bit disappointed in him.
Indeed.
Okay, it looks like Scrub is going to be restarting his PC because the connection was pain. I could feel it. I don't think my brain really processed that. But mostly because my brain can't process anything right now.
Yeah, I'm in the bone zone, man. I have not had this sensation ever in times of commentating, but this is it. This is definitely a sensation of maybe not enough food, too many brain cells lost, possibly even not enough water. I'm in the mix. There's been too much emotion exuded throughout the entirety of this tournament, just like to handle anything at the moment.
We're in the blender.
Okay, but it seems like they may be both restarting at this point, because I see Zero Shadow Blood has left. Yeah, so, you know, reset the bracket, reset the systems. That's how the PC Tag Tournament works. But yeah, I mean, not for nothing, this will be the guaranteed last set that we will have here at PC Tag and Chill, given that it is a reset. You're running out of time. Matt Torino, PC and Chill 29 for the free 50-cent donation if you haven't already. We're at $113.60. Again, shout out to Neo Celeste Gaming for the $100 pop bonus. You throw with a direct donation. You can do a direct donation too if you'd like. And check out the marketplace, Kaiten Books for Sale. Plenty of titles to choose from. Definitely appreciate you all who have been doing a free 50-cent donation using that code, but be sure to do so if you haven't yet because you are running out of time.
Yeah. Make sure you do that. Our players would definitely appreciate it. Just getting that tiny little extra bonus to the pot. It's quick. See. And, I don't know what to say. How do we fill this time? More importantly, how do I fill the empty void in my brain now that those cells are gone?
Dude, I already told you. Like, the filling in the time tech, I have run out of time to fill. Because again, every time that I do a filler, I'm donating a part of my brain cell to fill in that time. All right, so through the generosity of me, you know, just taking a chunk of my brain, filling it in for time. But there's been so much of that that I've forgotten how to do that because I just don't have the proper brain capacity to figure out how to do so again. So it's tough, man.
You know what? Man, what's the random fun fact of the day?
Random fun fact. Let's see what's So in 2v2 tournaments at BB Tag and Chill, there's been a unique winner for every single one of them almost. There's one team that has won two 2v2s. Which team is it?
Flowerman Eon?
Close. It's actually Flowerman and Razo. Flowerman and Razo are the only two to have repeat wins at 2v2 BB Tag and Chills. Now, Flowerman has won multiple 2v2s, and Razo has as well, and I think Eon as well. But as a duo, Razo and Flowerman are the only ones to win two 2v2s at BB Tag and Chill. That's the random fun fact.
All right. Well, that filled enough time in our empty void of a brain. Grand finals reset. No Fave Scrub still sticking with the Easy Oi. She hasn't left yet.
The 6P bot is here. Nearly an explosive round start with the happy birthday. Just wasn't quite able to confirm.
Doesn't block the 6P. Tries the beta burst. Nice jump out of the grab. You were getting smacked.
Ooh, 5A check. Yeah, doing a shot of blood stuff without a burst, having to take a good amount of that. Nice push block to get out of that corner positioning, though. Scrub recognizing the salmon situation, just getting out of there.
Nice tech out of the throw. Nice counter. Where did the Yumi come from?
There's a raw tag. I think Zero Shadow Blood thought they were out of dodge getting that push block, but it just ended up becoming a combo at the end of the day. Ooh, good challenge.
Going to be setting up another force sandwich. Nice block on it, though.
And not quite over yet. Oh, the TRM!
Yeah, finds a good place to burst out. Yeah! Yo!
I mean, optimal. You know, the throw bait, getting all that life back on Ragna, unburstable, and most of all, stealing a phone is Yo Fave Scrub.
Shadow Blood, phone has been stolen.
Oh. Hitting some buttons over here, man.
Yo,
oh, this is rough. Yes. Didn't do Dolly Hades, okay. Ooh.
You're getting smacked, but the Antier 5 probably just gonna cash out at a cross rate. Doesn't even need it.
Yeah, that was a valiant effort there from Zero Shadow Blood. Had to clutch defense on the cross combo and even found a good point to counter poke. Just didn't make contact with the Ragna. So Scrub able to maintain that corner positioning and get the first game post reset. We hadn't saw a phone still all day. It's not like we haven't had Ragna on stream. Scrub has had quite a few matches on stream, but that's the first phone still we've been able to witness.
Yeah, us. It was a burst interaction, but like as you said, it was optimal. Didn't have to deal with a burst. Just get hit by Ross Super.
Yeah. Yeah. Hopefully things have stabilized, connection wise. As we are heading into this game two.
My cause is just. I will not lose.
Here we go. What do we have on the round start? Ooh, 5A. I think Scrub was possibly jumping and just not blocking.
Yeah, he probably wanted to jump forward and maybe air contest, but zero Shadow Blood ready. Pushback out and excellent mash out. Isn't able to stabilize though, unfortunately. Excellent 4P call. I wonder if we're going to be swapping the Mizue. Yeah.
Ah, smart pushback to the Shadow Blood, kind of nullifying that quarter pressure a bit. Catches with the 6P.
Ooh! Wish the JA and gets the grab.
Yeah, it looked a little visually tricky there, but very solid stuff from Zero Shadow Blood carried to the corner. Yet again, what do we have on the Okie Doke? Constant pressure off these jump Bs. The push block though from Scrub. Susanoo is still in there.
He kind of a big boy. He's still staying in here. Not enough meter to cash out into anything super big.
Oh, that 6P just hitting so perfectly. The setup of Susanoo waiting in the front. And we have reset the position. We were just here 20 seconds ago. We back.
Yeah. The corner's back. Oh, excellent block on the fuzzy.
Yes, to have the eye for that and defend accordingly. Impressive from Scrub, but did not have the defense when they needed it the most. Unburstable super in the super connection to Zero Shadow Blood. Yumi finishing it off, and now it's just solo easy right here for Scrub.
That's up the grand Viper mix.
He got hit low, but pushed. I'm not gonna explain it, man. Zero Shadow Blood would be able to take game two inside of 1-1. Yeah, I guess he, but it looked like he was crouching. That's the thing. But I guess he push blocked. No, never mind. I'm not gonna explain it. I don't know why that happened. Like, how did he push block but get hit low?
Brother, I have no idea.
I got nothing. I have nothing.
Stop. Just give us a normal game.
Impossible.
I'm not good at this whole team thing.
Ready your weapon.
Game three, tied up 1-1. This is already reset. Zero Shadow Blood getting a solid game. Yeah. Wow. Wow. Stop. The jump forward was not met with the 5A this time. You can see
it. Why didn't Yumi fall out?
I got nothing.
Block.
Lots of push blocks here from Zero Shadow Blood. Trying to prevent any unnecessary damage. Good air to air. Oh, yeah, took a bit of a risk with throwing out that 5B in that scenario.
Gotta be careful with this Yumi, probably trying to find an opportunity to swap her out. Oh, when did Ragna get here?
I guess there was an active swap, but no! Did not go for the air raid before going for the active swap there with Zero Shadow Blood. Ragna living to see the light of day.
Gets good, but takes the throw, puts it into a sandwich scenario. Good block!
Oh boy, yeah, Zero Shadow Blood needs to be a bit careful. That Yumi is kind of low.
Not able to convert, but sets up a sandwich scenario, gets hit by the Grand Viper. Viper doesn't want to deal with any burst shenanigans.
Yeah, that'll do it on Scrubs. Easy UA just down to the Ragna Gauntlet. Hades, best move in the game.
Yeah, probably going to be cashing out with the DBD. Going to be putting Susan in the one-touch zone. Gets put low, but throw baits, but baits the burst as well. This is definitely a dead Yumi.
Man, and what a way to do it. That Susanoo has no life. Scrub has regained so much health. Activates the resonance right after. This is rough. Yeah. Ooh!
Oh, just played in the counter hit. Oh, no! Goes with the dead spike. I don't know if this is going to be a kill or not.
He's going to run out of resonance.
Oh!
jumps out, King, and will be rewarded for it. Yo, face scrub. Man, that was really close, because Zero Shadow Blood, it was a tough call to make of what you do. Like, do you cash in the super, or like, but I think even then, even without the resonance, the super could have been cashed in. I don't think it would have killed. It was just unfortunate stuff, even the off of a right call there. But Yo Fape Scrub able to, again, make sense of the chaos initially, and they are on tournament point. Yeah, Zero Shadow Blood has been able to run it back up until this point. The loser's bracket run, the reset, but now is on the brink of elimination. The Ragna Izioi for Yo Fear Scrub coming in clutch in the latter half of this set. Zero Shadow Blood thinking things over.
Oh god, I looked away and suddenly I was zero bar with everyone.
Get ready.
Let's hope that it's not a problem.
Yes, here we are. So yeah, Ragna comeback in order to take that game, which was definitely.
I'll show you.
I'm sorry, I lost my entire train of thought. My brain cells, dude. Yeah, I was gonna say it's interesting given like the being able to make the comeback without the Izioi six piece behind. Zero Shadow Blood has a nice lead, but it's just like speaks to the Ragna comeback potential when it comes to resonance and life still all together.
Oh, just gets hit by the boot.
Unfortunately,
drops. 6P is here. Yeah, still air blocking that. Oh, goes with a low. Excellent conversion. This Yubi is really low and baits the burst as well, but.
Oh, man. Yeah, just didn't have the proper confirm off that Izioi 6P to really cash in on the Susanoo. We'll be paying for it a bit. Ragna's bleeding.
Yeah. Can't make a final mistake.
Oh, man. Yeah, Zero Shadow Blast. Be really careful about calling to that Yumi, man.
Still doing it, just being well protected by these Susanoo buttons. Oh, baits the DP! Oh, drops the combo, unfortunately!
Oh, no.
Block on the overhead, has to deal with the Grand Viper. Excellent block, excellent tech out this low. And, oh, what a cross-up!
Yeah, Zero Shadow Blood doesn't have a burst, so they have to eat the entirety of this.
Oh, doesn't do the follow-up! Goes for the unblockable! Nope! Okay, there's the burst.
Oh, he? Jumping. Oh!
Oh!
What was that? He just ran for it. Zero Shot Blood thought it was a throw and was able to pretty much change the tides here altogether.
Yeah. Blocks the same side cross up overhead. Looking very close. Maintains the pressure with the 6B plus health span. Gets the low. Does it confirm into a kill?
Oh my gosh. There have been multiple kills here for Scrub, but it hasn't been able to cash in on any of them. Trying to get the arrow blockable scenario, but just a slightly missed space.
Oh, drop the combo! Wake up, Super! It's both characters!
And that will do it. Yo, Fave Scrub will take PC tag and chill number 29 in emphatic fashion. Reversal Karnic Scissors takes it all, and what a cap on the weekend we've had here of BB Tag and Chill tournaments and PC Tag and Chill tournaments. They return to form here for Guzman all together. Welcome back, bud. The month of April is yours for the taking. We were left astray with no BB Tag and Chill or PC Tag and Chill tournaments in March, but these have definitely been an onslaught of tournaments that we've had here in April. A refresher of everybody's memory at the top three here. This was not a Wednesday Night Fights. It was Forcer Kirby in third place, Zero Shadow Blood in second place, and Yo Fave Scrub ending first. Be sure to check out the match if you haven't already. You are definitely running out of time now. Code PC and Chill 29 will donate a free 50-cent donation to the pot. But that wraps things up. That is the end of the Lifetime movie. At the end of the day, Yo Fave Scrub with the Izioi was able to make that proud, and they're going to go get a steak dinner. That is the storybook ending that we have. But that is it. I hope you guys have enjoyed the return of Guzman Gaming Tournaments. Look, check out all the links there. Join the Discord if you want to maybe join a bracket in the future. Follow on Twitter to know all the latest updates about BB Tag and Chill and PC Tag and Chill tournaments. And subscribe on YouTube if the action was just so good. You got to watch it again. You can catch the VOD footage there. But I've been Kraken Atkins. I've been out of breath. I've been losing brain cells this entire time. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what day it is, what year it is. I just know that BB Tag is pretty sick, and I appreciate you all for watching and joining us here for some great BB Tag action. And thanks to Lon for sticking with me through it all. I think we're on the same page here.
All I have to say is I definitely kind of enjoyed. I say kinda because the emotional damage that I had to go through in this tournament was something else. But for the most part, it was great seeing y'all play. And I really appreciate you guys would come give us PC gamers a watch, no matter how long you watch for. It was just happy that you're here. This is a great community to be a part of, very cursed community to be a part of. A lot of Tagers here, by the way, in case you want some Tager. I'm just advertising PC Tag at this point. Come to PC Tag, it sucks.
That's a good tagline. But yeah, until next week or until next time, y'all take it easy and keep gaming. I don't have a tagline. I don't know why I'm pretending like I do. But thanks for joining.
Keep gaming, drink water, eat food, and remember, get some therapy.
That's it. Yeah, cut stream right there. That's perfect.
'Acabou decidindo, mas como o Zero tava falando, foi decidido bem no detalhe, assim, o Dragon Ball quase conseguiu levar com aquele happy birthday que ele pegou no antiaéreo. Mas agora eu preciso, inclusive, agradecer a galera que tá chegando aí do Guzman,